Disgusting. Okay, well, that's a qualifier. We'll get into some of those examples here. Why don't you pick one for us, and we'll jump into that here in just a moment. Also on the way tonight, it is Memorial Day, and so there, of course, are parades and things like that going on all over the place. I got into a parade today, and somebody asked me, Dave Ridley, where you were this morning, and I said, well, I don't know where Dave is. I thought maybe you'd show up with Mark and the family, because normally you, Mark, are there at this parade just kind of watching it. I didn't see you this morning either.
No, I showed up one time, Ian.
Oh, really?
And we happened to be in town on Memorial Day, and there's a Memorial Day parade. Jack is certainly going to want to see that, so we stopped down.
Gotcha.
So, no, I do not drive 9 miles to come and watch people walk down the main street of Keene. I can see that any old time. It's completely uninteresting to
me. Gotcha. I didn't know if you were doing it for Jack or whatever. So I guess I thought it was every year because we've done this 4 years now, and it was one out of three, which is a fair amount. Anyway.
Oh. I don't know. Sun Tzu said, in warfare, you attack what is weak, and you avoid what is strong. And of course, we're not in warfare, but we're in a conflict. And so the strong point, the enemy's strong point, is not his Memorial Day, or his weak point is not his Memorial Day parade, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's not a great place to bother the enemy, right?
Well, of course, that's one of the critiques that the event gets, or that what happens is we will walk in the parade after it is over. So basically, we will follow up the very end car in the parade and carry things like peace signs or peace flags, also homemade signage that says certain things. So I was holding a sign that said something against the war machine. And so we'll walk through the entirety of the parade, and people will see it, and some will comment. Some are, will make a snide or rude comment. And one of the comments that's most frequently heard, and we don't really get that many of them, but one of the comments that's most frequently heard is, this is not the time nor the place.
Because they have the peace parade?
No.
No, they don't.
That sounds like a variant on what you're saying there, that, this isn't the appropriate time or place. But to
it is. No, all time is appropriate to resist the government, I think. I just wouldn't think of that one as a priority. I wouldn't go out of my way for that one.
I see what you're saying.
What about what I think that they've really done right is that in the past it has been sort of some hardcore activists that take the peace flag out or whatever and they walk in the parade. But this year they had some children, right?
We had multiple families, actually, yes,
and
with children.
I think that makes a real difference when people see kids with a little peace flag. I don't think they can say much.
Well, they pretty much said everything they said normally other year. So I would say that the amount of derision was no less than it was on previous years. Amount of appreciation, I think, might have been a little bit up. And what I say by that, what I mean by that is we actually did have a couple people approach while we were sort of in the staging area. So here in Keene, there's the central square, this sort of this classic, iconic New England square, this gathering place. And that's kind of where the parade begins. But an hour beforehand, people start to gather there. And so we gathered there the hour beforehand and just kind of held the signs and the peace flag out in the median strip. So anybody who's driving by would have been able to see us there. And then once the parade began, we then got in at the end of that parade. But during the time we were preparing and waiting there, we did have at least two people come up and specifically thank us for being there. A couple of them wanted to take our picture and things like that. So that's always nice when that happens. And then actually Daryl told me that at the end of the parade, now, of course, during the parade, there's plenty of people who smile and who wave and who seem appreciative of the fact that we're there. But at the end of the parade, apparently one of the military guys, there's usually these military vehicles that are going in the parade.
Right.
Like big trucks and things like that. No tanks or anything, just trucks. Anyway, apparently one of the guys getting out of one of those military vehicles told Daryl, thank you, that he agrees with our perspective.
And interesting.
So actually got some kudos from somebody in uniform today, as well as just average people who were, sort of on the parade route. To me, I didn't have to go out of my way in this case. I live 5 minutes from downtown Keene, and that's a 5-minute bike ride, 10-minute walk maybe maximum. So no big deal for me to go to this thing. And I'm so grateful that many people came out this year because it really was a lot of fun. It seemed like the kids were having a good time. The kids, I don't think, were as aware of any of the derision that was going on. There was one lady that my favorite of all of the, well, this one lady, and then there was a heckler. But the one lady, she had her kids on the side of the street, and we actually heard her say, "Don't even look at them." Mm-hmm. And she turns her kids around and starts walking away at that moment.
Well, now, are you getting video and audio of these things when they happen and putting it on YouTube?
No, in this case, Dave, it would be too difficult for me to do that. And the only thing I will get video of is if something gets to an escalated point. I have my camera there. It's literally was strapped to me and ready to go if I needed it. But my hands are full with a sign or a flag. I was not playing videographer in this particular case, but what you're suggesting would be to have someone who is specifically a videographer.
No, you're missing an opportunity. What I would do in your position is put maybe a digital audio recorder on as a necklace or in my pocket or something like that, and just let it run the whole time. You might want to put an IM audio taping sign on
otherwise
you so
it
that
would
people
be
know.
Wiretapping.
Well,
perhaps.
I don't think it would, but just in case you accidentally walk into a restaurant or something, then it's private property. And that way you record everything that is said to you while you're there. I mean, you're going out there and getting yourself subjected to all kinds of abuse.
Thing
you
is,
might
most,
as well get audio of it and put it on.
Thing is, most of the things that are said from a distance. So the audio would not be very good, especially if you were doing it the way you're saying with like some sort of audio recording device. If I had a camera with a directional microphone on it that I was pointing at the people who were saying the things, then I would probably be able to pick it up in a reasonable
manner.
The
thing is that it will pick up, it may be technically a bad audio track, but it'll pick it up enough so that since you were there, you remember what they said, you can go back, you can find it, and you can subtitle
it.
I mean, I find that almost every time I go out to do a Ridleo, ambush interviews of politicians or something like that, that audio recorder constantly running comes in really handy because people, it's oftentimes the first 3 seconds of an encounter that count. Or you don't have any warning, you can't get to your camera in time.
You know, that's a good idea. I mean, because it would have probably picked up the heckler. We did have a guy who was walking along on the side of the road with
us. Oh, yeah, he was sticking with you.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Well, for a short period of time towards the end of it. And he was going, boo, boo, boo. It must have looked kind of crazy to the people, like, then he was walking by.
You didn't get any video or audio of this?
No, like I said, my video camera there, Dave, but it was only on a prepare kind of like if something happens.
Yeah, something was happening. You were there marching in a Memorial Day parade and you weren't supposed to be or there someone didn't like
well,
you being,
I mean,
at least.
We've actually done it for 4 years now, so as far as I'm concerned, we're part of the action. Our toll-free
number
here tonight is 855-450-FREE, but I would invite you to come along next year, Dave, and be our media guy and roll tape the entire time.
If it's convenient. Logistics drives policy.
All right, our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. So I thought it went well. I mean, I thought it was very good. In fact, I would say slightly better, especially in attendance. We had not quite a dozen people, and last year it was just me. So it was definitely a lot better this year. More on the way here, 855-450-FREE. What'd you do today?
Molly's been having 4 scoops a day, and she has slimmed down and gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen. You can't believe it.
Oh, yeah.
Her breath is better. She's just perkier. It's just so totally amazing. She's a gorgeous Springer Spaniel. She's 12 and a half years old. The last 2-3 years, she was really becoming very old, very slow, was very sad.
And I thought, oh, this is it.
I was driving along one day, and I heard this person raving about Dinovite. Dinovite.com.
Dinovite.com.
859-428-1000.
She's got life. She's got energy. She's got stuff to give.
She loves it. She chomps at every last single crumb.
These ingredients are natural. The flax and the yeast cultures and the grains.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
We're on our third order now. We just want everybody to know about Dinovite.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dinovite.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2237 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio waves. Toll-free numbers, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we've got Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm. Plus, you can get Bitcoin. Bitcoin, if you have not heard, is a decentralized internet currency that has sort of taken the world by storm. It's an amazing thing. I love Bitcoin, and I'm grateful for ExpressCoin being there to make it easy for people to get Bitcoin. And we're not just talking about Bitcoin. Litecoin and Dogecoin are also available from ExpressCoin.com. They are the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies because they're fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. Plus, they're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check, and you can start over at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, just go to expresscoin.com and you can get started there. Plus, they've got a smartphone app and you can use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. No transfer fee if you use coupon code FTL at expresscoin.com. So don't wait. Just go and grab some Bitcoin and get started with it. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We were talking about some of the Memorial Day goings on here in our very own Keene, New Hampshire, and as we reported recently over at freekeen.com, Dave Ridley is back, and he's now in our studio with us from ridleyreport.com. Dave, it's always great to have you on the show, especially considering, you know, you are an experienced activist. You are somebody who has done a lot of activism over more than a decade now, I think, here in New Hampshire as an early mover for the Free State Project. You came here in 2004, I believe you told me once.
Correct. And I actually moved to Keene when I first moved to New Hampshire.
And now you're back. It's been a decade, but now you've moved back to the area, which I'm really excited about. You were one of the inspirations to me moving here, as well as some of the other earlier movers. I would say you were probably one of the first five people moving to the Keene area. Would be
yeah, and I'm kind of itinerant, but I'm here at the moment.
It's true. Yeah. You could disappear next week, but and it's great to have you here at the moment.
If I remember correctly, you had begun calling Free Talk Live back when we were still a weekend show.
Really?
I recall that.
I called in from Dallas when I lived in Dallas.
Oh, wow.
Before, I remember getting on the air.
Pre-Ridley Report.
You had invited us, Free Staters. You joined the... You were Mephistopheles, right? Well, I don't know. I don't remember for sure what your handle was.
Yeah, that was one of my handles.
I thought you were that guy, and you put out an announcement that you had this great radio show, and we should call in. And you were right. We sure
you did.
You did, and we did.
Aww,
and I called in from in 04. Yeah.
When did you launch Ridley Report? Do you remember what year that was? It wasn't right away.
Oh, it was 07.
Okay.
Yeah.
07.
What year was the Free State Project? Did they pick New Hampshire?
03.
03. Okay.
Yeah.
So people had actually moved by 03.
So you would, I would just like to give our listeners a little bit of history about you, because I know a little bit of it. I don't know all of it, but you moved here as part of the Free State Project, and you got involved. I mean, to some extent, you were seen, I guess, out and about with some of the earlier movers like Russell Canning and, you know, those folks and some of the activism they were doing. But when did you start documenting it? I mean, was it when Ridley Report started, or did you do some documenting of it prior to that?
I didn't shoot any video until 05. One of the activists lent me a camera. I'd kind of gotten burned out on buying cameras because they seemed to break so fast back in those days, and they were more expensive. And he lent me one, and I shot some video of some of the stuff we did in 05, like Russell Canning's FEMA flag burn.
And were you shooting for
you mean the UN
other...
flag burn?
Well, there was that too.
Oh,
I didn't shoot any video of the UN flag burn, but I shot video of the FEMA flag burn.
I didn't know FEMA had a flag.
I didn't either.
We made one for them.
So, were you shooting for that videographer, meaning that you turned the footage over to him?
No, I just kept the copies of the video, waiting for the day when they'd be easy to dub off. And then years later, I dubbed them all off, and I use them as file video now.
Very cool.
I think some of it I uploaded raw. There's video of a car wash that we did for a fundraiser in 05 with Chris Lopez standing and talking to me. You know, I'll never be able to do that again.
Yeah, she's in a wheelchair now.
Well, and
you never know. Medical technology gets better over time.
Oh, yeah. But then there was also video of a bunch of people moving. It was one of the bigger, I mean, Evan Knappen moving in. It was a huge move. I mean, there must have been like 60 people there moving him in. That was 05.
You've probably recorded more video than any other activist up here. I mean, I've done a lot in court, like hours and hours of court footage. But as far as actual video of activism, you probably hold that title. You've got a lot of B-roll. Now, in the business, B-roll is considered, you know, sort of stock footage of things that are happening that you can use to fill in gaps and, you know, in an edit that you might be putting together. If you were, like, some of the videos you put together are sort of Ridley talking about opinions on things or opinions on strategy or activism or whatever, and you will usually illustrate those with as much B-roll as you can. That way it's not just you talking into a camera. The B-roll gives the viewer something else visually interesting to look at. Not that you're not attractive and pretty to look at, Dave.
It's just boring to see somebody's head bobbing down, up and down on a camera.
You don't want the same shot for 5 minutes straight. So B-roll breaks that up. How do you organize all of that footage?
It's just a matter of logging it. You know, after I've shot something, eventually, usually it'll be a month or two later, I'll get around to watching the whole clip and writing down what's there.
Are you actually writing physically?
Oh,
you
no.
Know, time
well,
codes?
Typing it.
I'm just
typing what's on file number 372 or something like that. Actually, I'm up to, I guess, 2,000 files now. And so what's on file number 2,000, we'll write it down. And then later on, if I need video of, if I need video of Ronald Leslie,
yep,
the firefighter who stole your cell phone or at least took it and, you know, and then didn't give it back and immediately when you told him he had stolen it.
Yeah.
To find video of him for today's video, I just typed the word Leslie into my searching document, and it went right to that 2009 video.
So is it all in one big document, one humongous text file?
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. Wow.
It's not that humongous. It's probably about, you know, 150K.
Well, I didn't mean the file size, but as far as length of like pages, probably quite a few pages.
Yeah, but you could never gaze your way through it. browse. No, you would just keyword search it.
Okay,
and
that makes sense.
So I just, the logging is designed to catch the keyword searching that I do 5 years later if need be. So that is pretty powerful, and that was something I discovered, you know, when I was in mainstream press. I worked at a normal TV station, and I went to...
Right.
I went to see JFK, the movie JFK, and I noticed how Oliver Stone was, he was taking what was essentially just a court drama and turning it into a very heavily illustrated court drama with really interesting pictures substituted for just the shot of the person on the stand talking. Mm-hmm. It was illustrated, and I thought, wow, I could do that with file video that I'm shooting out here, you know, in Wichita, because I worked in Wichita, Kansas. I get so much file video. If I just kept that more of the file video that I shot and logged it so that I could keyword search it, this would be really powerful.
Yeah, it's brilliant. I mean, yeah. I don't keep a lot of my video just because of space, of hard drive implications. What do? Do you have external hard drives full of video?
I have crappy video quality.
that's
one of the reasons why you see such low resolution is I'm keeping all these files.
Right.
But I can't keep them at 1.5 kbps. You know,
yeah.
I've got to lower the resolution when I keep them, and I actually am having trouble even getting good resolution when I first dub them at this point.
So if somebody wanted to donate to you, Dave Ridley, if they wanted to send you a big, beefy computer with a bunch of file space on it and a nice HD video camera, would you accept a donation like that?
I'd think about it, but the thing is you have to put together so many different pieces. That's the problem, is getting all the pieces together. I could get a good HD camera, no problem, but how do I make that work with Windows Movie Maker?
Yeah, good question. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Dave Ridley is with us here from RidleyReport.com. Maybe you've got a question for him, or you want to bring up whatever's on your mind. We'll talk about Memorial Day a little bit coming up.
It's Katie Armour's 15% off sale now through Memorial Day. All Katie Armour is now 15% off. Katie's all-new Level 4 body armor is made in the USA and can withstand the toughest of rifle rounds. Why would you buy anything else? That's Katie Armour's 15% off sale now through Memorial Day. Get your Level 4 body armor while you still can. Go to katiearmor.com. That's CATIarmor.com. Come and take it.
Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people. When the cleaners ruined some special clothing, all they could do was show us a sign that said they weren't responsible. But when they got the letter from one of our Legal Shield attorneys, he promptly gave us a check for $1,152. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com, or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Oh, is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission.
But I just
the
wanna...
Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the
I
Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. And, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated. So send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us on the air here and bring up whatever's on your mind. Coming up, Mark, I did say we were going to pepper these throughout the show. We should probably begin doing that. The 51 examples, ridiculous examples of waste on the part of probably the federal government. We'll get to the story here. Do you happen to have the source on this?
Yeah, it's from liberty247.net.
All right, we'll get into that here in a moment. But I also want, well, of course, we'll take your calls as well at 855-450-FREE. But I also want to tell you about ID Stronghold. If you've ever known someone or yourself been a victim of electronic pickpocketing, you know how dangerous this can be. Thieves, for instance, can pass near you with an RFID scanner and read the data on those RFID chips. It might be in your credit and debit cards. Those thieves can then use that information to charge your credit cards for their purchases, or worse yet, compromise your identity.
And yeah, now, that's the worst part.
Yeah, now thanks to ID Stronghold, there's an easy way to prevent electronic pickpocketing from happening to you. ID Stronghold has been making products to block electronic pickpocketing since 2005. So they've been around for quite a while. And some of their most loyal customers are military personnel that place a high value on personal security. Now you can have that same protection in the form of great leather RFID blocking wallets made by ID Stronghold.
Now I have one of these RFID blocking wallets. It's a metal clamshell.
Okay.
And it is thick. And I'm thinking that these are probably significantly better because they don't have that. They're more flexible. Mine's inflexible, and it's just big. And so I never have the problem of anyone stealing my credit card information. I don't know how often that happens to people, but that's kind of the nice thing about insurance is you just don't have to think about it anymore.
Yeah, and we're going to find out more about the quality of the product. It is on the way. We've actually got one coming in here, hopefully within the next couple of days, I'm thinking.
It'll probably be delivered tomorrow.
The mailbox store was closed today, so
yeah, it's Memorial Day, right?
But anyway, we'll let you know more about what we think of it here when it arrives. But it sounds like a great idea, and it makes sense, right? Like essentially a Faraday cage for your credit cards. You can switch your wallet to a quality leather wallet from ID Stronghold with built-in protection against electronic pickpocketing. Just visit idstronghold.com. That's idstronghold.com, and you can see their huge selection of his and hers wallets. Again, idstronghold.com, and tell them Ian Freeman sent you. All right, so our toll-free number here is 855-453. Robert is in Vermont, and then we'll get to one of these 51 examples of ridiculous waste. Go ahead, Robert. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Dave, Ridley, and Mark.
Hi, Dave. You and I, we met about a year and a half ago over at the Keene Activist Center, and I loaded you up with a whole bunch of quarters to give Robert it.
I can vouch for that. You must have given me 10 or 20 bucks worth of nickels, I think, and maybe there were some quarters. And yeah, those ended up saving many a motorist, I guess, because I gave it to the Robin Hooders.
There you go. Hey, Dave, I do have a question I want to ask you. You did a story over here in Vermont on a gentleman somewhere up, I think in the North Kingdom. I'm not sure. And the gentleman was an older guy. He had some trouble with trying to get into the courthouse because he was disabled. He was very old.
Wallace Nolan?
And I wonder if there was any outcome to all that, because I never heard anything else more from him. I just kind of really felt bad for the guy.
He lost in court. What was interesting, though, is so many times victory is a matter of going in and getting your backside kicked. That's what victory is, because it means you fought, right? And so Wallace was the perfect example of this in this situation. He had been targeted by the post office, I guess. they prosecuted him for the way he interacted with a postal worker that came near his house or whatever. And so he got some kind of a sentence or a suspended sentence or something like that. And so he retaliated by taking the people who sentenced him and taking them all to court, and basically almost all the people that were involved, in putting him on probation or suspended sentence or whatever it was. All of those people, he was able to put them on the witness stand, right? And so essentially he sort of turned the tables on his tormentors and ruined one of their days, at least.
He used to call this show a lot, too, with a lot of his stories of going to court and what happened with the post office and all of that. He was an interesting character. I think he's probably still kicking around over there in Vermont somewhere.
Yeah, I got an email from him 2 days ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's always got something going on, some sort of court case that he's filing against somebody, and he's one of those guys. He's like, one of those, I don't know what you call that, court animals or something like that, court denizens, constantly in court, messing with the government. I love him from that aspect. He's also a little bit pesty. He can get kind of annoying with some of the level of contact that he'll give independent media. I like the guy, I like what he does, but he's doing it in Vermont, which is not why I'm here, right? Like, I only have so much time that I can dedicate to people doing activism and sort of covering what activism they're doing. And so I tend not to spend my time covering Vermont, because we moved to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project.
Right?
And, again, resources are limited, so I can only focus so much. But that doesn't mean I don't appreciate Wallace and what he's doing. And if there were another 50 Wallaces, it would be a real tough year for the court system.
If there were another 50 Wallaces in Vermont, Vermont would have been the home of the Free State Project.
Could very well be. Robert, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Mark, let's try one of these 51 examples on for size here and see how that is.
Medicare Part B paid nearly 6 times more than Medicare Part D for the same drugs and equipment to treat cancer.
I don't know what the difference between Part D and Part B is.
Do you understand that one government program can doesn't talk to another? They're very bad at talking to each other, and therefore that one organization might be paying more for stuff than another?
Okay. I didn't know that there were two Medicares or whatever. This is news to me.
Yeah, news to me too. I don't know anything about Medicare, but it seems really odd that they're paying, significant 6 times more for drugs and the same drugs and equipment.
I would have expected that there is something even more abusive that we could talk about with the federal government. I'm a little disappointed with that one.
It's the first one. I mean, there are 51 of these things.
They could have come up with something better than that, couldn't
they? Yeah. Give us the juiciest ones that you find in there.
Two federal projects, one concerning the creation of a facility to produce fuel for nuclear reactors, and the other concerning a building to dispose of liquid waste from the first facility, remain incomplete. The National Nuclear Security Administration has already spent nearly $7 billion on these two unfinished projects, where they were supposed to only cost $4 billion overall. So they spent nearly double what they were supposed to spend, and they're not yet done.
So this is pretty much what all of the 51 are, just, they're spending a lot of money on something.
Well, that's what it is. Well, government waste.
Okay. Is this the one where they're like transporting nuclear waste all over the country? Or
I know they have had to do that. I think this is intended to prevent that from happening, at this location.
Oh, okay.
I don't know, Mark. I think I'm gonna cut this off here.
Okay.
I agree with Dave. These aren't particularly, useful or interesting. I mean, it shouldn't be a surprise
to
anybody listening.
They torture people.
Right?
Do we need to know anything else?
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, they're wasting money. You didn't know that about government? I mean, if you didn't know the government wastes money, well, welcome to the world.
Okay, right? This is my fault, because I partly advocated that this 51 be a top priority story.
Well, I mean,
we tried.
The government wastes money, and all you're going to do is when you be able to say that, look, here's some examples of the government wasting money.
Here's what I think this would be better for. It would be a great post on our Facebook and Twitter. That seems like it might be a good shareable story for online.
Sure, but you do know that the story of the $200 hammer got a lot of mileage in the past. I mean, that's the reason for
these.
That's because it was simple.
Yeah,
everyone knows what a hammer costs. They didn't have to go into, what is it, two paragraphs explaining that nuclear one?
Nobody knows about that. Right.
It's two sentences.
Okay, two sentences.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So thanks for that, though, Mark. It was a good shot. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Let's talk a little bit more about Memorial Day. Just not really so much the holiday itself. There is an article posted or that I saw on Facebook today, and actually it wasn't posted on Lou Rockwell today or even this weekend, but it was from last month, and it is written by a man who spent two tours in the Iraq War, recipient of the Combat Infantryman's Badge. He actually happens to live in Manchester, apparently, teaches rifle and pistol shooting. And here's what he has to say. Iraq was an ugly place, but it was also a dismal time in my life. My memories of the country are colored by my emotions, both the fear, anger, and contempt I felt toward the Iraqis, and the grief that recalling my time there brings to the surface now. We'll talk a little bit more about what Josh Holmes is his name, what he has to say about his time in Iraq, his reflections. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE on this live Memorial Day edition of Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You're listening to the best Liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us here on the radio at 855-450-FREE. I don't know if I pointed this out enough so far this hour. We're actually here live. I know a lot of talk show hosts like to take the day off for holidays. It's a good excuse to take a day off. But we are here on holidays because...
I didn't even know it was Memorial Day.
Yeah. I probably would have had no idea had I not known in advance that there was going to be this parade happening, because we've made a history out of going to these parades here in the last several years here in Keene, and sort of bringing out the what I call the peace contingent, where we will carry peace flags and anti-war related signs in the parade at the very end of the Memorial Day parade, to some people's chagrin, but to the delight of others. And so that's why I knew what day it was. Otherwise, I would just be calling radio stations and wondering why no one was answering the phone. But yeah, Memorial Day, and that means, you know, there's stuff to talk about in that area. But we're here live, and you can join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And Skype us at Skype username LRN.FM. Don't forget, if you want to help support Free Talk Live, one of the ways you can do it is by shopping with us. You go to shop.freetalklive.com. You can enter Amazon US, Canada, and UK. You go into the right Amazon for you and then buy what you need. It's Amazon, the same great prices and deals you're used to. Free Super Saver shipping, Prime, all that stuff. It's all the same. You're just entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a percentage of the purchase price. So whatever it is you need, you can go and get it and probably get a, you know, probably the best price for it over at shop.freetalklive.com.
Oftentimes Amazon does have some really great rates. You can hunt around, I think, on the internet. Sometimes they get better pricing, but man, you know, your time's worth something.
So let me jump back in here. We just barely got started on a story from LouRockwell.com by Joshua Holmes. He is a former Iraq veteran, if you will. I guess a former veteran. He is a veteran. Two tours of the Iraq War, has the combat infantryman's badge as a result. And he says that... the fear, anger, and contempt I felt toward the Iraqis and the grief that recalling my time there brings certain emotions to the surface now. In all the images I remember from Iraq, the common theme is how dirty and run down the whole place was. Garbage was...
Because they were at war.
Garbage was strewn across every field and piled by the side of every road. Even the intact houses were homely and in need of repair, and windblown dirt gave everything a dingy hue. Battered cars with flecked paint plodded down dusty roads. Earth-filled HESCO barriers topped with barbed concertina wire marked the territory of U.S. troops, which Iraqis were forbidden to enter. They say that smell is the sense most, or they say that smell is the sense most closely linked with memory, a piece of evolutionary biology designed to protect us from ingesting the same poison twice. It's true in my case. I remember Mosul, the most populous city in northern Iraq, for its open sewers, called wadis. They were slow-moving streams of water, yuck, excrement, and petroleum byproducts that ran between open fields and alongside roads. Their color ranged from a bright rusty orange through all the shades of brown to a slick, oily black sludge that I'll never forget. Now, that didn't have anything to do with them being at war, Mark. That's just their sewage system,
I guess.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm reluctant to say that about Iraqis. I bet that the system was... I thought things were probably better when Saddam was in the saddle.
I guess you could be right about that. I don't know. I've never been there.
Iraqis seem to believe that it's worse now.
Well, it would be hard to imagine that the sewage system would be too much different unless it had been blown to smithereens, I suppose.
I bet a lot of things were blown to smithereens.
One night, I would say it would probably depend sort of geographically, too. You never know, you know, which place he's talking about.
One night at 2 a.m., in this case he was talking about Mosul. One night at 2 a.m., my platoon was called for a quick response duty after a small kill team had engaged a handful of insurgents. The platoon that my buddy Doc Sanchez was a member of had been camped out in an Iraqi house and had observed some Iraqis digging a hole on the side of the road and apparently placing an improvised explosive device. They lit the insurgents up, unloading a full 200-round belt of ammo from the M240 Bravo machine gun before they lost sight of the enemy in a dark field.
That'll take care of the problem.
My platoon dismounted on the side of the road and swept the field, searching with night vision goggles and infrared flashlights for the dull black shine of blood on the tall grass. Finding it, we followed the blood trail to the edge of a sewer ditch, and a sergeant ordered three of us to cross so we could search on the other side. We walked across 8 or 10 feet of the foul slime, and when we came out on the other side, a thick black film clung to our boots and trousers up to mid-thigh. We didn't find any bodies, but when the three of us got back to our base, we were turned away from the chow hall and instead had to spend the pre-dawn hours scrubbing greasy filth from our boots and clothes. The other smells I associate with my time in Iraq have to do with bombs and death. Bombs leave behind a burnt chemical odor, similar to but distinct from gunpowder, stronger and more caustic. I would be happier if that were all they left behind. We rode in Strykers, 25-ton armored vehicles originally conceived to deliver troops to the front lines under the cover of an artillery barrage. They're bomb-resistant.
Artillery isn't used much these days. Not like, the U.S. doesn't have to deal with artillery much, I guess.
Their bomb-resistant armor made them ideal transports for Iraq after the insurgents adopted IEDs as their chief weapon for resisting U.S. occupation. Rolling on 8 waist-high tires, that armor saved a lot of lives from blasts that would have destroyed armored Humvees, including mine. The tremendous sound and the shudder of the car bomb striking the front left corner of our Stryker were the only warning we had that anything was wrong. Acrid, rust-colored smoke that poured into the belly of the truck filled my nose, mouth, and lungs, while a high-pitched ringing droned in my ears.
Yeah, I bet.
My platoon leader, Lieutenant McNaughton, came down out of the hatch with his face covered in blood, shouting to my squad leader to take over because his hearing was gone. Because of his own deafness, I couldn't hear Sergeant Varney's reply that he was deaf as well. The blood, thankfully from minor injuries, mingled with the shouting and urgency, and we quickly evacuated our casualties to a field hospital. The blast from hundreds of pounds of homemade explosives combined with 155-millimeter artillery shells had ground our vehicle's engine to a halt and had sent the car that carried the bomb flying through the air before it came to rest down the street. The following day, I was tasked with cleaning up the gore of the suicide bomber's remains off of our truck so the maintenance technicians could begin repairs.
Jeez.
With gloved hands, I held the pressure washer and peeled the scorched flesh off the battered armor plating. Some parts were recognizable, and that day I became thoroughly familiar with the reek of the burnt skin and hair that was fused to the truck's green paint. Who was this man who had tried to kill me? This was 2006. It didn't have anything to do with Saddam Hussein or weapons of mass destruction or any of the reasons that we had started the war over. He wanted us, American soldiers, gone, dead, if that's what it was, if that's what it took. He wanted it so much, he gave his own life for it.
That's generally where you get suicide bombers. You know, historically,
during occupation.
Yeah, historically, suicide bombers are closely associated with occupations. You know, there's often a religious bend to them, but not entirely. So, what the strongest correlation is that there's essentially an occupying government, and people believe, you know, nationalism is a strong thing, and you know, they want to be able to rule themselves. They're willing to do what it takes to create a better world for their children.
Is it so much nationalism, or so much just leave me aloneism? Could be some of that too, right?
I mean,
they weren't necessarily doing it for Iraq. Maybe so much they weren't doing it for their, you know, the vengeance of their families or whatever else.
It could be, but usually people are looking forward in these circumstances. Mm-hmm. You know, like revenge is a terrible reason to kill yourself.
So he said, I had no way of knowing whether he had a family or whether he had said goodbye to them, knowing what he was about to do or whether he kept it from them. The same way I lied by omission to my own mother so she wouldn't worry about me. I couldn't hate him. He had done what I would do if our roles were reversed. Here I was, wearing a uniform, carrying a gun. How could I condemn him for using violence to protect his home from foreign invaders? I would revisit those sights and smells again and again throughout my time in Iraq. Every dingy street was the same as the next, and the monotony and disquietude was only ever were only ever punctuated by death. The blackened husks of car bombs, the scorched limbs of a suicide bomber scattered like so much rubbish across the street in front of Bakaba's police station. The soldier whose litter I carried as he died from shock and blood loss before the medics could save him. When I think of Iraq, I'm sorry for all of the carnage and fear that we visited on those downtrodden, impoverished people. I feel indignation toward the rulers who lied to gin up support for this war of choice, who never once put themselves in harm's way or took responsibility for the suffering that they caused. Like Vietnam before it, Iraq will always be a reminder of the dangers that come from an uncritical trust in authority. That's from Josh Holmes.
This makes me think of a quote from Churchill, which I've just looked up from The World Crisis, his book about World War I. And he's talking about the Eastern Front, where both sides lost. He says, quote, 10 million homes awaited the return of the warriors. 100 cities prepared to acclaim their triumphs. But all were defeated. All were stricken. Everything that they had given was given in vain. The hideous injuries they inflicted and bore, the privations they endured, the grand loyalties they exemplified, all were in vain. Unquote.
Do you think that's how people feel with the Iraq War? Because in many ways, they feel like it was a victory. You know, like they can always say, well, we had it at one point. And, you know, when I left, we were winning. You know, that's an old Vietnam T-shirt. when I left, we were winning. And Vietnam wasn't lost by the soldiers. It was lost by politicians.
We're going to come back with more here in moments. Our toll-free number, if you want to share your thoughts on this, is 855-450-FREE, live Memorial Day edition of Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Shaquille O'Neal for Icy Hot.
If you've got pain, you need the patch.
The Icy Hot Patch. Powerful, targeted, fast-acting pain relief that stays put without the mess. Icy to dull the pain, hot to relax it away. In a variety of sizes, from back, shoulders, knees, even arthritis. So you're covered whenever and wherever you hurt. Stop pain right at the source with Icy Hot Patches.
Pain's no match for the Icy Hot Patch.
For temporary topical pain relief, use only as directed.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene and the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, May 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.04 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,204 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports in the 9 days since the fall of Palmyra, the Islamic State has rounded up government supporters and carried out mass executions, with the Syrian state media claiming over 400 people killed, mostly women and children. The Syrian Observatory for Human Rights confirmed the basics of the story, affirming it had documented mass executions in the ancient Oasis city, but putting the toll at 217. Among the 217, the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights said about 150 of them were captured members of the Syrian military seized during the fall of the region, with the rest being civilians, including a handful of children. The fall of Palmyra put the Islamic State even more deeply in control of central Syria and has expanded their territory in the country to the point where they are estimated to control about 50% of the nation by area. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI report. While awaiting a decision in civil contempt proceedings late last week, Arizona Sheriff Joe Arpaio asked the public to help fund his legal fees, according to a report. The Los Angeles Times quoted Arpaio as writing an email stating, "In some instances, I have to personally pay for attorneys to represent me in these cases. I do not have the personal wealth or the wherewithal to keep up with the costly demands of paying for attorneys to defend me." Arpaio is being sued by immigration rights groups and is in the midst of a contempt of court hearing over whether he disregarded a 2011 court order to refrain from profiling and detaining Latino immigrants. On Friday, Arpaio's lawyers filed requests for a new judge to replace U.S. District Court Judge G. Murray Snow. The filing reads, "No reasonable person with knowledge of the facts can deny that Judge Snow is now investigating and presiding over issues involving his own family." In 2013, Snow ruled the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office had systematically profiled against Latinos in the law enforcement operations. Arpaio is scheduled to appear before Snow in June, though the filing could affect the timetable. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans Program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports two people were killed in flash flooding and severe storms in Texas and Oklahoma that forced evacuations and rooftop rescues and left thousands without power. The National Weather Service reported river flooding across southern Oklahoma and central Texas, where 6 to 9 inches of rain fell between late Saturday and early Sunday morning. Flash flooding remained a threat on Sunday from central Iowa into southern Texas, where the heaviest rainfall was expected. The National Weather Service said as much as 3 inches of rain could fall in east central Texas on Monday, and possibly more in some areas. Helicopters were used to rescue people off rooftops in Hays County and central Texas. County officials reported on Sunday more than 1,000 people were rescued or evacuated from 400 homes. Local officials at an afternoon news conference said debris piles were nearly 20 feet high. An unidentified man was found dead from the flooding in San Marcos. In San Antonio, electric utility company CPS Energy said it would take up to 48 hours for power to be restored to 2,600 customers. In Oklahoma, which also had weekend flooding, one firefighter died in Claremore, about 30 miles northeast of Tulsa. He was responding to a call to help about 10 people trapped in their home by floodwater and was swept into a storm drain and died. Another firefighter who rushed to his aid was also swept into a storm drain but survived with minor injuries. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Bruce Springsteen completed his new sci-fi concept album Red Dust, which explores the lives of struggling 23rd century carbonite miners on Mars. The 14 tracks on the album address a range of everyday trials and tragedies faced by blue-collar Martian men, simply trying to put food on the table for their embryonically harvested juvenile clones while living under the hypocrisies of a corrupt planetary federation. In business, top financial experts have indicated that any hope of recovery for the struggling U.S. economy rests solely on Spokane, Washington resident Bill Laughlin, who is currently browsing the power tools section at Sears. At 10:10 this morning, Laughlin investigated a scroll saw, which sent stock soaring nearly 300 points. 15 minutes later, with Laughlin straying away to try on sunglasses, Congress called an emergency joint session to offer Sears tax breaks in exchange for sending an experienced salesman over to help. In other news, a local man pushes the 4 millionth button of his life, and an area teenager is smoking like he's been to f***ing war or something.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free. Bring up whatever you want. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Please do enjoy the features that we share with you on the site. You can create the content that you see on the front page that was put there by listeners like you and voted on. You can vote up what you like, down what you don't. Go there, get interactive, do it all for free at freetalklive.com. And joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian. We also have Dave Ridley joining us. Hey, Dave.
Hey.
Thanks for being here from RidleyReport.com. And, of course, Mark, you're here too.
Yeah, I am.
So it, coming up here tonight, it is the live Memorial Day edition. We talked a lot, though, about Memorial Day on Saturday, so I don't really want to recover or retread a lot of that that same ground, at least, you know, as far as what where we're coming from. We always bring stuff to talk about. So I can't say I really have any other Memorial Day-related stuff, but I do have stories about Amtrak, which you don't really hear about Amtrak very much. In this case, it's police harassment of people who are riding Amtrak. Now, there's no shortage of police harassment stories out there, but
again, it almost surprises me. I would have thought of, like, when I think of Amtrak, I think of an expensive ticket, right? Like, generally, my experience is it costs more to use Amtrak than it does
than a plane?
Yeah.
Really?
It generally does. You got to kind of be in it. It has to be the right distance and that sort of thing for it to make sense.
Have you ridden on an Amtrak?
Yep, I have. I also would love to take one down to Florida, take their auto car thing down to Florida. But
is that where you drive your car onto the train?
Yeah, you could do that in Washington, D.C. and then get off in like Orlando.
So the benefit there would be you'd have your car with you when you got there as opposed to paying for a plane ticket where you then have to rent one.
Yeah, but the benefit of driving a car down there as opposed to if I start in Washington, D.C. and drive down to Orlando, it's going to cost me significantly less to go there and I'm going to get there more quickly. So,
because you're stopping constantly with a train?
Yeah, this just train just takes longer. Yeah, I mean, there's lots of stops and that sort of thing. So you have to really kind of want it, you know, and I guess I haven't wanted it badly enough to pay the extra money and spend the extra time. Plus, if you've got a family, you've got to get basically a berth inside the train as opposed to, you know, sitting in a car where you can, you know, pack all your stuff up and that kind of thing. I just don't.
What about you, Dave Ridley? Have you ridden on Amtrak?
I don't have a single Amtrak anecdote to share, but I did ride the trains in Croatia a lot when I was there in the 90s.
Are they government trains?
Yeah, well, probably. Yeah. You know, and this was when you know, Croatia was at its second worst that it's ever been in history, right? They did horrible things during those times. But the police on the trains, they only appeared at the like the border. If I was at a border, then there'd be a police, and they seemed to be pretty nice. They were nice to the Bosnian refugees that I was with, and they never bothered anyone anywhere else that I ever was, you know. And people actually used the trains. There were people. They were full of people, you know. So they was actually serving a purpose. I bet those Amtrak. Do you even have people in them?
That's a good question, Mark. Was it busy when you were riding the Amtrak?
It didn't start out busy, but it got pretty busy between New York and Washington, D.C. That's what their biggest run.
Okay. So here's a story from TheAtlantic.com. Two recent articles about the Drug Enforcement Administration harassing Amtrak passengers have elicited responses from a number of Atlantic readers. Hey, they've more or less written, I've been harassed aboard Amtrak, too. For those who missed the earlier stories, they summarize here and they link to them. The DEA took $16,000 from Joseph Rivers, and they harassed mathematician Aaron Huser and appear to have illegally searched his bag. The DEA is mentioned again in what follows, though other stories concern different law enforcement organizations. The common theme is the harassment of innocent people without probable cause to think that they're doing anything illegal. As Brian Doherty noted at Reason, I don't know if I'm going to pronounce this right. Gendarme?
I met Brian.
G-E-N-D-A-R-M-E? Is that how you pronounce that?
I don't know what that is. Yeah.
The Gendarme Bothering Innocent Travelers. It's another name for cop, I think. On Trains was a stock trope of movies and books about malign European regimes, and now it's a regular feature of train travel in the United States of America. You said, Mark, during the break, I think, that they brought a dog on when you were on the train.
It's true. They walked a dog down the aisle and, you know, just kind of walked a dog down. I can tell you the guy I was sitting next to, he's actually a senior staffer for a senator. Mm-hmm. He's like, oh, God, I hate when they do this. He basically said, I hate cops. You know,
interesting.
He didn't say that, but, you know.
I bet you the guy he works for likes cops and has probably voted for these kind of things.
I don't know the answer to that.
The incident of harassment weighed on one reader for many years. Here's this one of the stories. I'm still very disturbed by an event much like yours that happened more than two decades ago. I still feel so violated and was approached exactly in the same way as others in your story. I had a sleeper car as I was going from Austin to Los Angeles. Mine happened in Arizona, don't remember exactly where, but I was finally told when I tried to repeatedly ask why I was being harassed is that I matched a description of a drug dealer.
Yeah, well, that's a pretty common thing to say. Here's a couple of things police say. They say there's been a complaint in the area, and they say that you matched the description of somebody else. And many times...
And you can't challenge that.
Well, you can't on the spot. what we'll find out is later when, you know, when these things hit the news, usually they don't hit the news because the person just, okay, whatever, man, do what you got to do. But sometimes when they do, you know, for instance, they shoot the guy because he acted strangely, you'll find that the description they're talking about is like nothing like this other person. You know, the description was for a white guy. It's a black guy or whatever. I mean, it can be so far off. This is just crap they say.
And this is so many more missed opportunities. How many of these people are getting video? It always seems like the average American...
Well, this
American
was 20 years ago, this guy.
Oh, so 20 years. I thought it was
we'll give him
years.
A break.
Okay, all right.
But some of these are going to be
newer.
But
it's happening recently. Yeah. And people are, where are the videos? Where is the video? If you don't get video, it didn't happen.
It didn't happen.
Yeah, basically. Or at least audio.
Yeah, I agree with that, David Lee. And of course, now there's no excuse not to have video, especially with the ubiquitous cell phone that almost every one of them has a video function at some level. So
people are just so busy being sheeple, they're afraid to pull the phone. And of course, I actually might be afraid to pull a phone out of my pocket too in some circumstances, because the police might think it's a firearm if they're already on
there
you.
There is that.
But I mean, I had a martial arts guy who used to tell me, the fight doesn't start when the first punch is thrown. It starts when someone's in your face, you know, and when the police are starting to walk up to you, a civic conflict has begun. It's time get your phone out and participate in that civic conflict by getting video and putting it on YouTube.
Excellent advice.
You can.
It never hurts to stop down. We'll continue his story to recommend some specific tools. Bamboozer is the tool that I use personally on my smartphone. Now, if you don't have a smartphone, then you might want to consider investing into a small video camera that you can carry with you, because I don't think all the dumb phones have a video feature. I suspect many of them still do not.
Well, then you can call one of the Porcupine 411 numbers.
If you live in New Hampshire. But,
well, there's a lot of other states that have them now.
That's true. I don't know if it's a lot, but there are at least a couple of other places that have Porcupine 411, which is a phone number you can call and leave a message, and then that message is distributed out to recipients. How well used those other systems are, I don't know. I know that even Pork411 has had some, I think, fallen into some level of disuse over the years, simply because there are just some people who are frustrated with the amount of messages being left there that they didn't consider to be useful. But I still use it. I still get those messages.
I unsubscribed for that reason.
You did?
Yeah, it's crazy people leaving messages in many cases. I'm sorry, I just don't have any interest in it.
Yeah, to me, if that happens, I'll just skip the message. It's important to listen to those in case somebody needs some help.
Your dedication is entirely different, and many of them are across the state. You know, I mean, you're not talking about stuff in my town. I'm a volunteer firefighter. I go to people's problems on a relatively regular basis, but what that was a lot of noise to me.
Well, anyway, if you want to learn more about Pork411, you can go to porcupine411.com, and they'll tell you how to get signed up if you want to create one for your area, and it's a really useful tool, I think. Do you still get them, David Lee?
I go to porcupine411.com to listen to them.
So you go
I don't
on
get them
your
on email.
Own.
They just stopped coming to my email for some reason, and I never repaired the,
I see.
The break.
All right, so of the three in the studio, I am the only one who receives these messages as they are distributed.
Yeah, I've been meaning to get them back on email again, though.
I think it's worth it, because there are people that sometimes need help, and they'll put it out there, and the more people we have listening to it, the more likely those people are going to get help. Anyway, it was this lady writing here again 2 decades ago. At that time, she was a 30-something female traveling alone with luggage that she had in her room because she had a room. And I was told, she says, that if I didn't cooperate and let them search me, that they would arrest me and take me off the train. That sounds like a lie, because you can't be arrested for not consenting to a search, right? So if that's just, they're lying to you to get you to give them consent for a search.
And this is one of the things is that many people will hearken back to when police were better. I'm not sure they ever were better. I'm just pretty sure we didn't have video of it.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. It's easier to get the stories now about the bad cops because we can jump over mainstream media's heads and create our own media. So when somebody does get video, as Dave is suggesting, they don't have to go through the mainstream media gatekeepers to get that video out. So that's why it may seem like things are worse now. 855-450-FREE. More coming up.
Warning. If you've recently declared bankruptcy, you're going to want to change the station. Because there's an alternative to bankruptcy, and it's faster than you'd ever think possible. But if you've already declared bankruptcy and have missed this opportunity, you'll want to change the station now. Here it is. Right now, the company that has resolved more credit card debt than anyone in the U.S. is available to settle your debt, too. You may reduce your debt with one low monthly program payment. If you call right now, Freedom Debt Relief will show you how low your monthly program payment could be for free. Call now. 1-800-399-1993. That's 1-800-399-1993. If you're struggling with debt, this could be your answer. And the bigger your debt, the more money you could save. To find out for free how much of your hard-earned money Freedom Debt Relief could help you save, call now. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to may be even more nervous than you are. And the way things are now, your references have never been more important. Here are three tips. First, know that employers are checking. Every hire is under the microscope these days. Second, they won't just be checking references you provide. Figure that all of your ex-employers will get a call and be asked, would you hire him or her again? Third, assume you will be Googled. So before you apply, remove all those party animal photos from your Facebook page. Even if you're not in the job market, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency, and Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, and spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the airwaves on this live Memorial Day edition of the show at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you want to talk about something related to this particular holiday or whatever is on your mind. It goes here if you dial in and join us. Also, you can join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Just send a contact request over via Skype, and we'll approve it once we notice it coming in. And then at that point, it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype, and you'll sound great almost all the time compared to a regular phone line.
FortGalt.com. What they're doing down in Chile is they're building this, some freedom lovers, folks that are entrepreneurs, freedom lovers, into collaboration. They're creating this condominium complex. It's small on the basis of a condominium complex because it has small units, but they have big plans. What they're doing is just creating a great deal of sort of shared spaces, you know, restaurant, coffee shop, business center, where people of like mind can get together and work. So they'll have, you'll own your own sleeping unit, basically. And there's little as $10,000 for these units. And you don't have to have it all at once, by the way. You can sort of pay an they have the sort of installment thing so that you're not taking risk up ahead because it isn't yet actually been built. I did get to talk to Luke, who's one of the organizers. He came to Bensonwood, which is just down the road here from Keene, New Hampshire, and they're building very high-end looking stuff. Go check it out. I think you'll really love what you see there. At the very least, you should be informed on it. It's fortgalt.com. They've got a great video and a great website to look at. Galt is spelled G-A-L-T, so it's F-O-R-T, Fort, G-A-L-T.com, fortgalt.com.
All right, our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We're sharing with you some stories from the rails. TheAtlantic.com is talking about police harassment on Amtrak. Now, we've had plenty of police harassment stories here on Free Talk Live. There's no shortage of those. But I can't say we've really ever had too many of them that have happened on Amtrak. That doesn't mean they aren't happening.
Apparently they have happened for people taking pictures of trains. We had used to get a lot of those. Basically, you know, that for some reason or another, people...
Terrorism.
Yeah, you're a terrorist if you're taking pictures of choo-choos. Now, you got to consider that there are a lot of people that are really into trains, mostly males, mostly a bit older, but, you know, some younger ones too, little boys and older guys. They can be really into trains, and they want to take pictures. They want to know about them. I was walking down the trail behind my house, a couple of years ago, and they were asking that trail used to be a railroad line and there was a couple on it. And, you know, they were asking me about sort of trains in the area. And I'm like, I don't know really much about it or what this rail line used to be or anything like that. I do hear a train every once in a while at night and I don't know which one it is. And he told me which one it was. So, you know, like he knows what train it is that makes noise at my house. Mm. And I didn't know.
It makes sense that something would be wrong with the trains, right? We're living Atlas Shrugged right now.
And that the main trains are a big part of Atlas Shrugged.
Yeah, I guess the details the downfall of the train, the rail lines and whatnot.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of detailing the downfall, I've actually got a story about the decline of newspapers, which is kind of a fascinating subject we've been following for years here on Free Talk Live. I want to get into that, but let's read some more of the stories here from TheAtlantic.com of people's experiences on Amtrak. Now, the first one we read was from 20 years ago, but some of these are more recent. They've been getting emails. They ran a couple of stories recently over at The Atlantic about one man who had the DEA steal $16,000 from him while on an Amtrak. And
that's going to kind of make you mad.
Yeah, and then they also harassed a mathematician who appeared to have, and they appeared to have illegally searched his bag. Here's another reader who had some cash taken. He says, I quit using Amtrak due to a 4 a.m. search and robbery of $300 in cash. Thank God for traveler's checks, he says, by cops in Buffalo. Good luck with your story. It's nice to see the rest of the country finally getting it. There has been a police state, a profit-driven one, rising in this country due to drug prohibition. And of course, that's absolutely true. That's, you know, the number one reason why these searches are happening on Amtrak trains. It's not so much for terrorism. It's certainly for catching drug dealers and people with drugs.
I think what we've got here is that situation where a line is easier to attack than a point, right? Because when you're at your home or at your job, you're sort of at a point. But the line that you take to get there, they can intercept you anywhere along that line and pick the place. And with a train, it's even worse because they know where it's going to stop.
You can't avoid it.
They can do all kinds of things while it's still in motion if they want to.
Right.
So it's the ultimate line. And lines are dangerous strategically. Points are better, especially points that are moving randomly, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I think
you're absolutely right, because if they stopped travelers in their cars, there'd be an incredible amount of pressure over that, especially like on the interstate. So if you're talking about sort of state-to-state interstate travel, this is a really great place to mess with people is on the trains, because you have all the time you need.
They're a captive audience. And also,
even TSA doesn't do that.
Well, yeah, and that's a great point. And also, look at what happens with the DUI checkpoints here in Manchester, or in Manchester, New Hampshire. There was one just this past weekend on a Friday night. 30 to 40 activists came out to respond to this checkpoint, which means that they're spreading out. They're all over, you know, this area where the checkpoint is. They'll go up to the, you know, the street, the turn off street before the checkpoint. They'll hold signs saying, you know, police checkpoint ahead, turn now. You know, if you want to avoid this thing, they'll signal to people and, you know, wave them down and
stop
them.
They've got a big laser light sign that they can put on the side of a building if they need to.
This is pretty powerful because, you know, over the years, everyone is looking at these numbers going up, you know, and I was looking at
the numbers of checkpoints.
Some of the images from the, the numbers of activists at the checkpoints, especially the Manchester checkpoint. I was just looking at some of the pictures from that checkpoint. I was thinking, wow, the police are seeing these pictures too, and they got to be kind of unhappy about this.
The police used to, I haven't heard this this accusation in a while, but the Manchester police used to consider this Free State Project to be a gang. The terminology that they used.
They supposedly had non-gang in parentheses next to it, but they have an entry when you're getting booked at the police department. And I don't know if it was just Manchester or if this is statewide, Mark. But we heard about it happening in Manchester, where they have a gang selection option. So sort of like they're selecting your height, they're selecting your, you know, the color of your eyes when they're booking you. And then one of those things is gang affiliation. And so under gang affiliation, they had Free Stater within parentheses and then said non-gang in parentheses.
Yeah, that's why they try to get – that's what the cops get or the enforcement officers get at the jail for trying to categorize everything. Not everybody fits into a category.
So
I can understand why they would want a category like that. I mean, Free Staters, there's different types of them, but they fit into some categories.
They definitely want to create files and information about Free Staters. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I mean, the cops here in Keene are well briefed on the Free State Project participants. Chris Cantwell, for instance, has had cops call him by his first name, who he's never seen or talked to before. Right. Yeah. So obviously they know who he is, and that means somebody has told them about him. Whether they're doing their own research on their own or not is another question. But it was interesting. Chris was talking.
It's unlikely they're going home and doing their own research. They probably
Some of them are.
Some of them are, certainly.
He talked to one cop recently who's a listener of Chris Cantwell's podcast. So that's one of the things I love about this, because that happened with us, too, when we moved here to Keene years ago. I went on a police ride-along, and the cop who we were riding along with said he was a listener of Free Talk Live. So I love it. I think it's great that the police are listening and watching
our media. That was what, 08?
Yeah, something like that, 07, 08, somewhere in that range. Our toll-free number tonight, that video still is online. If you want to go and check it out, just search for Keene Police Ride Along on YouTube. It's multiple parts, and it's really good, I think. There's more coming up here in moments. We got enough time for you if you want to share your thoughts. Maybe you've been harassed on Amtrak, or you just want to talk about whatever police interactions you've had. DUI checkpoints, maybe you've helped with those too. Free Talk Live.
The economy is teetering on the edge. Spending and taxes are at all-time highs. Average Americans are hanging on by their fingertips. Is the American dream dead? Can it be restored? Join us at Freedom Fest, the world's largest gathering of free minds, in Las Vegas, July 8th through 11th, to hear the historic debate between Paul Krugman and Steve Moore. Plus, Senator Mike Lee, publisher Steve Forbes, billionaire Steve Wynn, and media mogul Glenn Beck tell us how America finds her way back. Discover the new American dream. Register today at freedomfest.com to find out. That's freedomfest.com.
It's Katie Armour's 15% off sale now through Memorial Day. All Katie Armour is now 15% off. Katie's all-new Level 4 body armor is made in the USA and can withstand the toughest of rifle rounds. Why would you buy anything else? That's Katie Armour's 15% off sale now through Memorial Day. Get your Level 4 body armor while you still can. Go to katiearmour.com. That's CATIarmor.com. Come and take it.
Free Talk Live.
My father was a police officer most of my life. He went to prison for police brutality. Wow. And my father was the chief.
What was he like at home with you when you were growing up? Was he violent with you?
He never with me. He practically ignored me, actually. I never really had a relationship with him, but extremely violent to my mother. He beat her up practically every day of my life.
Oh, my God.
He never touched me or my sisters or my brothers.
Did he have a drinking problem?
No, he's never drank alcohol.
Wow, so violent without alcohol. Very interesting.
I lived in a very small town in West Virginia, and my sisters and I and my brothers, we could do whatever we wanted. There were no laws for us. I could drive as fast as I want.
You said that he abused your mother, beat her frequently. Did she ever leave him?
Yes, numerous times, but she couldn't do anything because there was no help for her. There were no police to call to help her. There was no help for her because my father was very well connected. He knew everybody in the state.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Back with more Free Talk Live. Maybe you've been harassed while on a train or elsewhere. You can talk about wherever the police have harassed you, but specifically we're focusing on Amtrak stories right now. The Atlantic.com recently published a couple of stories about police harassing customers on Amtrak, and that of course resulted in people sending in their own stories. So there is no shortage of those. We'll get into a few more of those. Then on the way, the decline of newspapers. Plus, Dave Ridley wants to talk about jury outreach and the sort of explosion that has happened on that front here in New Hampshire recently. That's all on the way. Of course, you can join us here. We're live on this Memorial Day edition of Free Talk Live at 855-450-FREE. You know, you get a day off like a lot of people do on a day like today here, Memorial Day, and you know, sometimes you run out of things that you can do. It's a great time to kick back with a magazine. But wait, magazines are kind of having trouble in the print world, at least. We'll talk about newspapers here in a moment. They're having difficulty, too. But there are new digital versions of magazines available. This is kind of the new hip way of consuming magazines. It allows for magazine content to be augmented with digital bonuses, extra photos and videos and things like that. And next issue is a really neat product that that I've been using here to read through magazines. There are over 150 magazines available on the Next Issue app, and we're talking about big names, everything from ESPN to Sports Illustrated, Men's Health, Esquire, Car and Driver. A myriad of different magazines are available here. People, Entertainment Weekly, I've got Consumer Reports is in my list of magazines that I've been reading. And I was just looking at Wired, actually, a moment ago. They've got an article in this month's Wired, which just came out. All right, when I say this month, I mean June, because that's how the magazine business works. They release their next month during the previous month.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, in the June issue of Wired, there's a guide about podcasting. It's Gearhead is what it's called, and On the Air. So they're giving podcast equipment recommendations, suggestions as to, you know, what kind of microphones and other things you might need if you wanted to start your own podcast. So that's just one example of a lot of different content that you can grab in the Next Issue app, and you can go and try it out for free with a $15 savings that gets you in for a free month over at nextissue.com/FTL. There's no commitments. You can cancel at any time, and you sign up today for your free trial with nextissue.com/FTL. It's your favorite magazines available to you anytime, anywhere. You can eliminate the clutter on your nightstand or in your closet or your bathroom, you know, the old stack of magazines where you just throw the old magazine when you're done with it. And one of the cool things about Next Issue is it actually can be shared. Your account, your one account that you have, can be shared with up to five people. So you're not just buying for you. You can actually buy this for, you know, your loved ones as well. And it's all the same account. Plans start as low as $9.99 per month. You get access to over 150 magazines. So it's kind of like the next the Netflix for magazines. It's available for iPad, iPhone, Android tablet, and smartphone. So whatever smartphone device you have, this will probably work for you.
Well, you could buy it as a Christmas gift almost.
Absolutely.
For yourself, and then give the extra freebie parts to others. That's a nice cheap
it's
Christmas.
It's a great deal. And you know, if you think about it, you break down the numbers, the plans start at $9.99 a month. So that's like the price of two magazines at the newsstand. And you get 150 plus here with nextissue.com/FTL. Go get signed up for your free trial today. You got nothing to lose here. Nextissue.com/FTL. Back to more Amtrak stories, interactions with the police. This is somebody traveling from Amtrak or on Amtrak from Chicago to Toronto says the train was boarded by U.S. Customs agents who proceeded to take me and my luggage off the train into a small shed where everything was searched. The train actually waited during this time.
Oh, jeez.
And I was the only one taken off the train. I had been riding with the rest of the economy passengers and not in a sleeper car. After a 15-minute search, I was told to go back on the train. I then stated that I thought it was unfair that I had been singled out, and they told me that it was because I was from California. Another reader was questioned in Nevada. I just read your article about the DEA harassing people on Amtrak. Here's my story. I took the California Zephyr from Chicago to San Francisco in April 2014. Shortly after departing Reno, a man with a badge identified himself as with the DEA. He asked to see my ticket, where I was headed, and why. He asked where my bags were, and I told him I had one with me and two more on the lower level. He asked to search my backpack, and I consented. He didn't care about all my other bags. For most of the 52-hour train ride, those bags were unattended and out of sight, but largely available to all of the passengers. Even if he searched and found a moderate amount of drugs in my bags, how does he prove they're mine? This may be why he was unconcerned. I did not see him ask any questions of anyone else in the car. I was young, 30, white male, traveling alone. But that's
the other thing. People are so helpless. Americans seem to be so helpless when they're confronted by a bureaucrat. When a bureaucrat asks you a question, your response, you don't have to do a lot of thinking. It's just, am I required to answer your questions?
That's always a good question. It never hurts to ask a question back. I mean, obviously, you can keep your mouth shut. You can always say, and this is probably one of the smartest ways to go about it, is to say, well, now you have to retain your right to remain silent.
Yeah.
So I would like to use my right to remain silent. Thank you very much.
You can
shut up. But if you do want to speak, I think your approach is a good one. You know,
there's a reason why they let the Fifth Amendment into the Constitution when they were building it, right? They figured it probably wouldn't hurt the government very much, and it doesn't, because when you plead the Fifth, or at least in a context of a police encounter, you've sort of given up a key weapon. Your voice is a weapon. It's very valuable. And if you completely give it up, you've surrendered a lot of territory.
Well, and they are going to use it against you as well.
But if you're only asking questions, it's fairly difficult. And if you only ask a couple, it's going to be fairly difficult for them to find something there to incriminate you with.
Excellent advice. And combining that with what you said earlier, Dave, to record video and then ask those questions on video. That way you can get everything on the record, because, you know, you don't want them saying you said something you didn't say. You know, just fabricating something completely to go after you for later on.
They can
on.
Do it. I mean, you know, they can do it.
Well, we know from testimony at Rich Paul's trial with the FBI that when the FBI is interrogating people, they don't record those interrogations. So
that's the FBI. A lot of police organizations do. The FBI certainly should.
Yeah, I don't know which ones do and don't. All I'm saying is you certainly can't count on them to provide the objective recording of that. You need to be the one who does that. Here's another one. I use Amtrak as often as I can. When I read your article, I was shocked because I also went through a series of incidents. My job used to be as a paid political operative. Basically, I beat Republicans for a living. I would always try to go by sleeper car because your meals are included and the bathroom facilities are much better. Plus, the quiet calmed my nerves. When I moved home to Arkansas from West Virginia in 2000 and again in 2005 from Milwaukee to Little Rock, I had similar interrogation scenes. Why was I traveling with so many bags unchecked, etc.? Well, I'm moving home. Hello. When you're a staffer, it's more than clothes. You live on site. because of fundraising campaigns sometimes don't pay you until a month in. When you win, you're often paid in cash. I had snooping conductors wanting to know what was in my boxes and bags. I showed them because, honestly, I had nothing to hide, but I felt intimidated.
Yeah, that's what that guy gets for helping authoritarians in Washington
now,
or wherever he was.
Now, what do you say, Dave Ridley, to this excuse that, well, I had nothing to hide, so I might as well just show him all my stuff?
Well, you do have something to hide. Everyone has their Social Security number to hide, for instance, no matter how good they are.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone has something else to hide that's perfectly good, but someone else might think it's bad, right? No one is capable of being an open book safely.
Yeah, that's true. And you don't really know what you need to hide. There's so many things.
You can't know what's in there, yeah.
Well, there's so many things that are that are illegal now that you may not realize are illegal. And then, whoop. You just got caught with one of those things, whatever it was, and that's because you consented to the search. Now, of course, I suspect – now, I don't know, though. I don't know how different Amtrak is from, like, the airplane. Obviously, you know, an airline, you've got to go through the search to get on the plane. Searches don't tend to happen after you go through the checkpoint, but they can. They can pull you aside, and they can – they have actually happened to me.
Yeah. we took a trip where you were somehow –
more than one trip, actually.
Yeah, blackballed, and they shook us down on every leg.
Yeah, I've been blacklisted, and they would actually check the – they would actually search people randomly – I'm putting quotes around that, air quotes – at the line to actually get on the plane well.
And I have this theory, too, that a certain type of resistance with just the right demeanor – authorities will respect you a lot more for that than they will for helping them out or doing what you're told.
Yeah, I
respect
think
and
right.
like.
Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We got one more comment, one more story from Amtrak, and your thoughts are certainly welcome on Free Talk Live.
The Atlas Society's Atlas Summit is just around the corner, June 18th through the 21st, right before Porkfest in Nashua, New Hampshire. Connect, grow, have fun with longtime objectivists and people just learning Ayn Rand's philosophy. There are discounts for students, locals, and one-day rates at atlassociety.org. The event is jam-packed with speakers. Come and be a part of the most important objectivist event of the year, the Atlas Summit, June 18th through the 21st, Nashua, New Hampshire, atlassociety.org. 20% off with coupon code FTL, atlassociety.org.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
You've heard them on Alex Jones. You've seen them on Ancient Aliens. Now come see them live at Contact in the Desert 2015 in Joshua Tree this May. Experience 4 full days of science-centered lectures, workshops, intensives, and fieldwork on ancient astronauts, extraterrestrial intelligence, human origins, crop circles, contact experiences, UFO sightings, and more. Meet Chariots of the Gods author Eric von Daniken, Ancient Aliens host Giorgio A. Tsokalos, New York Times best-selling author David Wilcock, Dead Doctors Don't Lie author Dr. Joel Wallach, astronauts Edgar Mitchell and Story Musgrave, Earth Files publisher Linda Moulton Howe, author Jim Mars, and many of the world's most respected researchers and scientists exploring answers to one of the greatest questions of all time. More speakers, more panels, more things to do. Join us at the Joshua Tree Retreat Center, which has a long history of sightings and contact experiences. For advanced tickets and conference schedule, go to contactinthedesert.com. That is contactinthedesert.com.
Are you getting squeezed by the economic downturn? Hey, you were doing fine. Then, all of a sudden, you're having a tough time paying your family's credit card bills. Maybe you were downsized or even lost a job, but you still owe 10 grand or more in credit card bills. And you just can't afford the minimum payments anymore. We're here to help. We are the Genesis Debt Partners. We know the secrets to negotiate better terms with your creditors. Make a free 10-minute call right now and learn how we can help you get out of debt. 800-981-7590. If you owe 10 grand or more in credit card debt and you want to learn how you can pay less and get out of debt faster, call right now. 800-981-7590. 800-981-7590. Get out of debt now. 800-981-7590.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. Join us here on the live Memorial Day edition of the program. That's right. We don't take time off on this program. We are here 7 nights a week, as many of 365 days a year as possible. The only way we would not be on generally is if for some reason we, you know, can't get a board op to come in, which we almost always can. So we're here. And thanks to, by the way, thank you to Genesis Communications Network for continuing to provide us with even holiday live programming.
That's right.
We're glad to be here.
We've been on the air every day for many years.
That's right. So you can join us here on the air at 855-450-FREE. We've got more from the Amtrak world with multiple stories from people about them being harassed on Amtrak trains. We're going to continue that here in a moment. But first, we go to James. He's in Kalamazoo, Michigan, listening via TuneIn. Hello, James. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Dave, Ridley, and Mark.
Gentlemen, good evening.
Hi there.
First off, I was really excited to hear that Dave Ridley was going to be on. And Dave, I just want to let you know that no fewer than 3 people here in the Kalamazoo area were inspired to become activists simply because of you. So I just wanted to say, you're known. So
Dave Ridley is a phenomenon.
Thanks.
And I've got to say, I'm so grateful that he's here in New Hampshire and cranking out the content that he does over at RidleyReport.com. There are more people, Dave. I don't know. There may be more people who've come here because of you than Free Talk Live.
That would be saying something. But yeah, I think it's all about the clicking. You know, the ability to click on things that are in the video or to get from that video. Because when people watch one of these videos, they're already on the internet. Mm-hmm. And so many people who listen to Free Talk Live are driving, and it's harder to take action while you're driving.
Point.
Maybe that's the difference. But I definitely have, a tiny fraction of the audience of what you have. It's probably a 1% of what you guys, I only have like 22,000 subscribers.
It's hard though to, you whoop our butt when it comes to subscribers. I mean,
YouTube.
Well, not just on YouTube, but on audio. I mean, we don't have more than 2,000 to 3,000downloads
per
show.
Maybe it's the number of hits is much lower than the number of people that actually hear it is much lower.
That's true. We have radio stations, over 150 radio stations. So the number of ears listening, we've got more of those. But as far as like dedicated people who are subscribing to your content, we were just actually looking at this the other day. We had a wine tasting event actually, and Dave, you were there for this, and we had talked about how in the past you had claimed to be the number 2 most popular YouTube channel in New Hampshire. And the number 1 channel that you were citing at that time was WMUR, which is the big name kind of ABC News affiliate here in New Hampshire. And I went to their YouTube channel and I went to your YouTube channel. And what I noticed was that you had 4 times the subscriber count as their YouTube channel. Now, that's not really truly comparing apples to apples because WMUR gets most of their views on their own proprietary viewer. So when you go to their website, they have a viewer that's in their page with the story that they're showing. That's not a YouTube-based viewer. So we don't actually know how many people watch that. I suspect it's quite a few. But as far as actual YouTube subscribers, you knock them dead.
Well, now, James, are you still on?
Yes.
I had a question for you. Are those activists are also signed up for the Free State Project? Are they getting the heck out of there and coming here where it counts?
Well, one of them is an open carry activist. He's a friend of the Free State, so I don't know if he's actually going to become a participant. And the other one is not sure yet. They have, you know, a big family that they don't want to leave and everything. Mm-hmm. But I know, as I've said before, I'm moving myself. But I'm just trying to create, you know, before I do, kind of a network of liberty-minded people here before I leave.
No, be careful. So, don't do anything that's going to get you nailed down there while you're there. Get out while getting's good.
The last thing you need to do is catch criminal charges and then be on probation.
Yeah, no civil disobedience, just essentially outreach and information for people.
It's famous last words. I've heard that many times for people that get charges and stuck.
So the irony is I'm actually watching on Amtrak Pass as I speak to you guys, and I wanted to bring up something that I saw, and I'm by no means an expert, but there is an activist in Ohio. My mom's ex-boyfriend, I'm still friends with him on Facebook, posted it today, and simply all he says to police officers, and there's videos of him saying it like 5 or 6 times, and it leaves them dumbfounded and walking away, is, "I don't answer questions."
Well,
that's all he ever said.
I don't like that, because you're making a claim that you're going to have to back up. I guarantee you they can torture you into answering questions.
Okay. I can definitely see that. I just, there was a case recently, I guess, in Texas where somebody was picked up and they started talking to the police officers. And then halfway through, when they asked him a question, he just shut up. And essentially, they claimed that the Fifth Amendment did not apply to him at that point because he never invoked his desire to claim, you know, to claim.
Unfortunately, there was a Supreme Court case that did determine that you need to invoke your right to remain silent, which seems pretty contradictory, but that's what they decided. So that's probably accurate.
So that's all I wanted to bring up is, you know, as far as the Fifth Amendment, you know, the Supreme Court is now telling us that you need to invoke that before
it's
legit.
It's
crazy.
Yep, it's true. Thanks, James.
Anyway, that's all I have. Thank
Appreciate
you.
Appreciate your call tonight.
Thanks, James.
Yep, toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So the final story, at least for this edition, on Amtrak, the final Amtrak, we still got a full hour of Free Talk Live to go, but the final Amtrak story of Amtrak harassment from theatlantic.com. Traveling westbound on Lakeshore Limited in 2012, I recall being woken up by either Border Patrol or a state trooper and asked for ID in Syracuse around 1 a.m. The Lakeshore Limited, he says, does not cross international borders. The story was this. The law enforcement agent, who was very polite, woke everyone up gently, one at a time, and asked if they were U.S. citizens. Almost everyone said yes, and those who said yes were left alone. I said no, as I am not a U.S. citizen. And then I was asked for ID. As it happened, I did not actually have any ID on me except for a local government employee ID issued by a New York State authority. Since I was not crossing international boundaries, I didn't carry my passport nor my USCIS permanent resident card, and do not routinely carry my driver's license unless I'm driving. I think technically I was supposed to carry some form of government-issued ID while traveling on board Amtrak.
Yeah, you probably, as somebody who's a non-citizen, you're probably required to be able to identify yourself on a relatively, you know, I mean, don't you think the government would want to force everybody to identify themselves? So
yeah, but wait a minute, Mark. I mean, our friend Sam Dotson traveled on planes with no ID previously.
Yeah, that's true. But I think the government's going to have a much more difficult time requiring a citizen to show ID than they are a non-citizen. Like there's a few classifications of people that nobody gives a damn about. Convicts, non-citizens, certainly illegal immigrants, young people oftentimes. Like nobody wants to defend these people. It's just like, well, why in the world would I care? You're a non-citizen. You're in this country. You better carry some. You're dangerous. You could be a terrorist. You better carry some kind of documentation. You know, like it's just the average person just doesn't care.
Well, this sounds to me very similar to the border checkpoints. The internal checkpoints and the actual border checkpoints, where they are asking people if they're U.S. citizens. And we've seen videos where people have successfully refused to answer that question and have been allowed to travel on through.
I can't imagine on a train that you're going to be able to do that.
But this is what people get when they demand more immigration control. They get people messed with who are nice people, or they get themselves messed with, or their families.
Awoken from a dead sleep to ask if you're a American citizen.
U.S. citizen.
Or for a U.S. citizen. Now, Mark, you're just speculating. You don't really know, right?
Like, okay, well,
you're saying there's going to be some extra consequence here. And
yeah, you're going to be a badger.
It's the exact
every...
same question. So to me, they're asking the same question, the same answer, which would be to not answer and to, let's see, what's a typical approach from somebody who's at one of these checkpoints? Something like, am I free to go? Well, I guess, yeah, it would be hard to ask that question.
Yeah, that's the problem, Ian. There's nowhere to go.
Right.
You see, when the cars are piling up behind you, the bureaucrat with the silly little badge and funny little uniform, that person is experiencing a certain amount of pressure to let you go because, you know, you're clogging up their works.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas when you're on the train, this person's got nothing to do but bother sleeping people and ask them if they're U.S. citizens, and 99% of them say yes.
Well, maybe Ridley's approach of am I obligated to answer that question?
That's the best thing to do, but you've got woke up out of dead sleep.
Or, you know, better yet, no disrespect is intended, but am I obligated to answer your question? You know, it's all about demeanor in modern day America. Demeanor trumps morality in the average American's mind. So if you're doing a terrible thing and being very nice about it, that's how that got into that article, you mm-hmm. know, then they will like that. They will like you better than the person who's doing nothing wrong and being shrill.
I agree with you, but I think that in many cases, Americans are just simply the very fact that you refuse to answer the question is going to be several marks against your demeanor already. Like, you could be the sweetest person in the world in
don't try to be sweet. Just fight them. They'll respect that.
Well, that's the bureaucrats, but not the...
Non-violently, obviously. But,
you're talking sort of about the PR value, and I tend to agree with it.
All right, there's more on the way here. Hour number three is coming up. We got the live edition of the Memorial Day version of Free Talk Live. Continuing here in moments with Ian, Dave Ridley, and Mark. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And I do have something else for Memorial Day coming up. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
What are you doing?
Looking for the best hotel value in America.
That's easy. It's America's Best Value Inn.
Really?
Sure. They have over 1,000 hotels across North America.
Okay, that's good.
They offer free Wi-Fi, continental breakfast, and HBO at most locations.
That's even better.
And when you join their free value club, you get 15% off, room upgrade, and late checkout when available.
You're right. America's Best Value Inn is the best hotel value in America.
Book a room today at abvi.com.
Done.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene and the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, May 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.04 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,204 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports in the 9 days since the fall of Palmyra, the Islamic State has rounded up government supporters and carried out mass executions, with the Syrian state media claiming over 400 people killed, mostly women and children. The Syrian Observatory for Human Rights confirmed the basics of the story, affirming it had documented mass executions in the ancient Oasis city, but putting the toll at 217. Among the 217, the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights said about 150 of them were captured members of the Syrian military seized during the fall of the region, with the rest being civilians, including a handful of children. The fall of Palmyra put the Islamic State even more deeply in control of central Syria and has expanded their territory in the country to the point where they are estimated to control about 50% of the nation by area. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, while awaiting a decision in civil contempt proceedings late last week, Arizona Sheriff Joe Arpaio asked the public to help fund his legal fees, according to a report. The Los Angeles Times quoted Arpaio as writing an email stating, "In some instances, I have to personally pay for attorneys to represent me in these cases. I do not have the personal wealth or the wherewithal to keep up with the costly demands of paying for attorneys to defend me." Arpaio is being sued by immigration rights groups and is in the midst of a contempt of court hearing over whether he disregarded a 2011 court order to refrain from profiling and detaining Latino immigrants. On Friday, Arpaio's lawyers filed requests for a new judge to replace U.S. District Court Judge G. Murray Snow. The filing reads, "No reasonable person with knowledge of the facts can deny that Judge Snow is now investigating and presiding over issues involving his own family." In 2013, Snow ruled the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office had systematically profiled against Latinos in the law enforcement operations. Arpaio is scheduled to appear before Snow in June, though the filing could affect the timetable. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports two people were killed in flash flooding and severe storms in Texas and Oklahoma that forced evacuations and rooftop rescues and left thousands without power. The National Weather Service reported river flooding across southern Oklahoma and central Texas, where 6 to 9 inches of rain fell between late Saturday and early Sunday morning. Flash flooding remained a threat on Sunday from central Iowa into southern Texas, where the heaviest rainfall was expected. The National Weather Service said as much as 3 inches of rain could fall in east central Texas on Monday, and possibly more in some areas. Helicopters were used to rescue people off rooftops in Hays County and central Texas. County officials reported on Sunday more than 1,000 people were rescued or evacuated from 400 homes. Local officials at an afternoon news conference said debris piles were nearly 20 feet high. An unidentified man was found dead from the flooding in San Marcos. In San Antonio, electric utility company CPS Energy said it would take up to 48 hours for power to be restored to 2,600 customers. In Oklahoma, which also had weekend flooding, one firefighter died in Claremore, about 30 miles northeast of Tulsa. He was responding to a call to help about 10 people trapped in their home by flood water and was swept into a storm drain and died. Another firefighter who rushed to his aid was also swept into a storm drain but survived with minor injuries. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Today's most popular video games take place in dangerous post-apocalyptic landscapes. But are these games enough to prepare our kids for the actual post-apocalyptic future we will all soon face?
Well, I think these games are quite effective at teaching our kids skills like finding shotgun ammo and leading elite squads of super soldiers.
But these aren't the advanced skills that they're going to need. They're going to need the more practical skills like how to find drinking water by collecting the morning dew in human skulls.
Or how to deal with depression when the sun is blocked out for 500 years by a cloud of radioactive dust.
Absolutely. Now, that's the type of knowledge these kids are going to need when their world has been turned into a brutal hellscape.
But these kids said that they know how to find items to barter at weapon shops and how to use medicine packs to heal zombie bites.
The games make it all seem deceptively simple. I mean, in the future, a kid's not going to be able to kill a 6-foot-long irradiated beetle just by pressing a few buttons, and he's going to have to get down there with an axe and hack and hack and hack.
This is the Onion News Network.
Talk Live. We're back with more here live on this Memorial Day edition of the program. Of course, you can join us on our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, or join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Joining you in studio tonight, it's me, Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
Dave Ridley's here, too. And Dave, it's been great having you on the show tonight. I know you wanted to talk about jury rights outreach, and I definitely want to discuss that. Plus, coming up, we've also got the declining value of U.S. newspapers. The Pew Research Center has looked at some of the numbers, and it's not shaping up too hot for those in the newspaper business. I want to get into that, too. But, Dave, you've been really impressed, I guess, recently with the explosion over just the last month or so of jury rights outreach that has been going on here in New Hampshire, specifically jury nullification outreach, where jurors are being informed of their rights. And this is not just a New Hampshire thing. It's happening, you know, in other places, but it's really happening here. Concentrated activism going on here in New Hampshire because of the Free State Project. But jury nullification is a nationwide thing. And it is your right as a juror to vote your conscience in a case. So, you know, they don't tell you this in court, but you as a juror have the absolute right to ignore the evidence. You know, let's say that Mark's on trial for being caught selling marijuana.
Yeah.
And he got caught red-handed, undercover deal. There's video. There's audio. It's clear you sold some pot. A conscientious individual who knows about jury nullification on that jury could vote not guilty despite the evidence because that juror believes the law is wrong, that the law should not be enforced, that the law should not be applied in this case, whatever. If that juror says, I don't think this guy should go to prison for this, he can vote not guilty. And that's the essence sort of jury nullification. And that's what activists in New Hampshire in various different places are looking to communicate that those ideas to the people who are coming into jury duty. And you have taken note of this recently.
Yeah, it seems like it's been spreading. You guys have been managing to do it regularly here in Keene.
For years, we've done it here in Keene for a
long
time.
Yeah, we've had flashes in the pan in Manchester where we did it. I've been to a couple out there.
Right.
But now it looks
Grafton had done it for a while,
they're
too.
They're starting to have a regular outreach at Manchester, it looks like.
That's right.
They're going to have one at Laconia shortly. They had a Dover one, I guess, the other day.
Yep, and
it's starting to catch fire a little bit. And
that's like half the state right there.
That leaves the
yeah,
other,
it is.
That leaves the other question open, though, of whether it's having much of an effect. Because it seems like so many people just kind of ignore. They'll take the flyer, but they'll do what the judge wants them to.
Yes.
And,
oh, yeah.
Well, you know, it's almost like something else needs to happen to push this over the top. Either where it becomes really mainstream, or maybe you've given the person better armor to defend against the judge and the other jurors.
Pamphleting is incredibly powerful because it puts ideas in people's heads, even if they don't use those ideas right away.
Not right away.
Let's not forget, this is liberty in our lifetimes, not liberty next week. Unfortunately, it didn't happen in Lloyd's lifetime. That's an inside joke for a guy who
an early mover who died.
Who was rather old. And
he died just hours, I think, after being photographed at a jury outreach event.
Hmm.
Or it was a court event involving Free Staters.
Yeah, at least he was active right up to the end.
Yeah.
And the difficulty is that, you know, people, these ideas, it takes time for people to change their lives.
That's true.
You know, I think that the best we can hope for is just to give people a little room, give them some ideas, and see what happens.
So just to answer your question, though, a little bit further, Dave, as somebody who – I'm the one out there doing this every month, basically. I mean, there's –
Yep, you are a lead on that.
In Cheshire County, you know, sometimes someone will come to help me, but for the most part, I'm there alone doing it. And really, you don't need more than one person to do it here because there's only one entrance to the court, and I can handle opening the door and handing people flyers at the same time. That's not a problem. If I have a second person, it makes it a little easier because then one person can open the door and the other person can hand the flyers out. But nonetheless, when I'm there alone, I still get 90% penetration with those flyers. Most everyone who walks by me takes one, and they're usually very grateful, you know, for being given the opportunity to have this. And then the way it works out here, and I don't know if this is the case in all the courts in New Hampshire, but here they'll impanel the jury pool for 2 months. So they'll show up 1 month, they'll all take the flyer, and then I'll be out there the next month offering them the flyer again because there's a chance that somebody who didn't take it the first time will take it the second time. So yep. I'm still there. And so that would be their opportunity to tell me something, right? Like about, oh, well, you know, we had those confiscated from us. No one's ever told me that. So that's good news because I suspect someone would tell me because we do get information sometimes from people that are inside courts about, you know, what's been going on the inside. And so that hasn't happened where someone has said, oh, well, they've been confiscating this or they told us to hand them over or something like that. And I have had compliments from people as well, like, you know, verbally appreciating the fact.
What's your ratio for go to hell free stater versus, you know, thanks for the info?
Next to zero go to hell free stater.
Mm-hmm.
And
I know that there was one guy one time that kind of gave you trouble about opening the door for him. But he wasn't really a juror.
I don't think he was a juror.
Yeah, I think he was
a lawyer.
The
guy who threatened me with a lawsuit for taking his picture?
Yeah, something like that.
That's an attorney.
Yeah.
And he never sued me, by the way. So called his bluff on that one because I took his picture.
I guess it's another situation where it's an opportunity to go ahead and record what's happening to you and just, you know, put an I'm audio taping sign on and record mm-hmm. everything, but maybe that interferes with the handing out of leaflets if you've got that sign.
Yeah, I guess that's one of those activist things that I sort of do in the vacuum, if you will, because I don't generally document those incidents. I do have my camera nearby, so if police or somebody comes and, you know, starts to cause an issue, I can quickly grab the camera and roll with it. But every now and then there will be some sort of documentary crew who'll come out and take video of me doing that. And just generally, most people are very, very friendly and receptive, and I feel like that's a good thing, right? That they're not in Florida, my experience was different. There were a lot of people in Florida when I did some jury outreach down there years ago.
Yeah, I remember you were trying to get me to help you out on that one.
Yeah, and that's where I was, I wouldn't say harassed by the police, but they gave me a little bit of a harder time than up here. But the people were less likely to take the flyers in Florida. I would say it was more like 50%. Would take it in Florida, whereas more, you know, here it's closer to 90 to 100.
Well, it's another country. It's supposed to be different.
Do you think it is?
Do you think that to some extent you've gotten better at it? Like the things that you say perhaps have gotten better as opposed to?
I couldn't tell you, Mark. I don't think that it was. I can't say for sure what my approach was in Florida. We're talking about more than a decade ago.
Yeah, sure.
At this
it
point,
was that long ago.
Or about a decade ago. But I think that it was fairly simple. I mean, really, you don't want to say very much. That's generally my approach is to just simply say, you know, good morning. Here's information about your rights. You know, your rights as a juror.
Mm-hmm.
You know, something very brief. They don't have time to listen to whatever it is you have to say. So, you know, they want to get in that courthouse.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm wondering if there might be more interesting things for us to do while we're inside as potential jurors. Like if you get called on jury duty.
Now that would be very interesting.
I haven't been
called. That hasn't happened to too many movers for the
free state. It actually has. See, this is one of the things I see because I'm out there, Mark, is okay. I get to see who all the free staters are getting called to jury duty. I can tell you it's happened to not just free staters, but also local liberty-oriented people as well. So folks like Nick, who used to be the host of Free Minds TV, I've seen him go in. There's a young lady here who's a free stater, Shauna Varen-Swearingen, the former president of the Free State Project. I've seen him go in for jury duty. So those are the kind of people who absolutely will give feedback, right? When Varen-Swearingen goes in there, the former president of the Free State Project, if they start taking flyers from people, you know, confiscating flyers, he's going to come out and he's going to tell me that, and he never did.
There are several things that could be done inside one of these buildings if you're called and hauled in. Mm-hmm. I haven't been since I was here. But one thing, what I did when I was called for jury duty in Dallas right before I moved, I took a wad of Free State Project literature with me with tear-offs on it so that mm-hmm. it had the URL. You could tear it off and the phone number. And I pasted that, covered that courthouse with – with Free State Project literature.
Probably not the best approach for New Hampshire.
And yeah, you would use a different type of literature, but while you're in there, you could paste that entire interior of the courthouse with literature about whatever you wanted the court, you know, people to see.
I suspect that it wouldn't last longer than the amount of time you were there to keep an eye on it, if even that. I mean, court security is going to see you doing that, and they're going to come confiscate that. They're not going to let that stand for very long.
You know, but every 30 minutes, maybe it's appearing in the bathroom and at the stall, you know, captive audience.
If it's in the stall, it'll stay for longer. But I thought you meant like putting on poster boards or something like that.
The other option is don't wait around for a victimless crime to acquit. Acquit everybody for everything. That will get their attention.
I can't advocate that. Yeah. I mean, you know, no, that's not going to fly with people.
The reason if you want, I'll explain why I'm advocating
I want to hear that here
in
a moment, because to me, that's just not going to fly with a lot of people, like, you know, acquitting a murderer. I don't think that's going to be very popular. 855-450-FREE, but we'll find out what Dave has to say about it here in moments. Plus, the declining value of U.S. newspapers. How bad is it? It's Free Talk Live.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison.
His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's toll-free, 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Our Skype username here is lrn.fm.
We had a wine tasting here at the Keene Activist Center. I don't know. Has it been a week now, Ian?
Just about. Yeah. Well, that was Thursday, I think, or something.
And there was a really great Spanish garnacha. Is that how you...
Sounds right to me.
Garnacha?
I've never heard of it before.
I hadn't either, but it was a pretty darn good wine.
Yeah, I polished that one off. It's good.
What Cameron Hughes does at chwine.com is he goes around, he buys the extra bottles and sells them direct to customers from these vineyards, the best vineyards in the world in some cases. And obviously they're going to make too much wine sometimes. So he buys them, sells them direct to customers. He has a different label on them, but that's really the only difference. It's the exact same wine that you can pay a lot less for. So we recently had Lot 446. This is the Spanish Garnacha. And it's a fantastic everyday drinking wine. It's a great food wine. It's only $10 for our listeners.
Cheap.
Yeah, it's an amazing value. It's one of Cameron's favorite everyday wines, and it's one of it's really, I thought it was great, and it'd be really great with sort of tasty food like red meats and spicy stuff. You can pick up a case. It's perfect for summer barbecues, graduations, and a great Father's Day gift. Mm. It's amazing. This online exclusive for our listeners. All you have to do is go to chwine.com and click on the microphone in the upper left and enter coupon code FTL. You get free shipping.
Still.
Yep. Free shipping and this exclusive garnacha for only $10.
Now, you've got to buy three bottles to get the free shipping, but still, that's nothing. I mean, $30 for three bottles of wine there. And yeah, that's if you're getting three garnachas. You can obviously get whatever bottles you want.
Get three garnachas. It's a great deal. Now, wine's heavy and expensive to ship, so obviously the shipping's a big deal. Wine Spectator recently rated two of Cameron's amazing cabs at over 90 points. These are high-quality wines at an awesome price.
Yeah.
The only way to get this exclusive free shipping offer and this great rate on the Garnacha for $10 is to go to chwine.com, click on the microphone in the upper left, and enter our code FTL. You will not regret it.
All right, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. As we continue here, there's the story about the newspapers I want to get into. But Dave Ridley, you just said acquit everybody. You've been talking about jury rights outreach. And
yeah, that's crazy talk.
Asking about, you know, what are some other ways besides just handing out pamphlets that we can promote the idea of jury nullification, your right as a juror to vote your conscience in a case. Are you serious?
I can back this up. I got this idea from my brothers and sisters in the black community in Tyler, in Texas, when I worked there. Actually, it was a little bit after I left that they started doing this, but there was, you know, as anywhere else, a corrupt legal system. Folks started acquitting anyone who was black. Because they figured that so many black folks they just didn't believe anything they were hearing.
Okay.
And in fact, they probably shouldn't have believed anything they were hearing.
It's a good point. Cops
now,
lie.
At the time, I didn't like that idea. But if you think about it, ethically speaking, if you vote to convict someone and get them sent to jail at taxpayer expense, you essentially initiated force against the taxpayer. If you voted to acquit, and even if it's a heinous murderer and you voted to acquit, you still have the option of doing something about the problem yourself.
A vigilante justice.
Yeah, I don't think I would actually just go out and wax a murderer. I think if I were to get a jury to acquit in a case like that, it would be my responsibility to do something myself. I don't know what it would be.
I don't think it's fair, Dave, to say that voting to convict someone is aggression against a taxpayer. I mean, the taxpayers are going to be aggressed against whether or not you vote to acquit or not.
No, the jail's
but it's
going to
cost an additional...
No, it won't. The jail's going to get what it's going to get.
That's additional bloody sandwiches?
That's a little bit like saying someone else is going to do it, so I should do it. Well, no, someone else is going to do it anyway.
So this I'm glad you brought this up because I have talked to jail superintendent Rick Van Wickler. He's the guy who runs the local jail here that some of us like to call the Keene Spiritual Retreat. Rick is, for those who are new listeners to the show, Rick is actually kind of known as a jail warden because he's a member of Law Enforcement Against Prohibition. And so curious about this because I've seen the numbers as far as what does it cost to put somebody in a prison cell in New Hampshire, and I think it's like 35 or 40 grand a year or something like that. And so I had previously thought, oh, well, you know, that would mean that the jails would get more money for the amount of people that they put in there. And Mark, you had batted me back by saying, oh, well, it's the same price regardless. You know, they might have to spend an extra bit on bologna sandwiches. And so really what he told me was that he asks for the maximum every year. He asks for the amount that he would need to have a full jail, essentially, as far as his budget is concerned. So from what he told me, and I don't believe he was being dishonest, it sounds to me like it doesn't matter whether or not if they take you tonight and put you in Cheshire County Jail and they keep you there for 2 months or whatever for non-cooperation or civil disobedience, their budget will not go up. So that's what I was told. And whether that applies to the state prison, I don't know. But that's what I was told about the local jail.
It's the drop in the bucket phenomenon. But, you know, I have a responsibility for every drop I put in that bucket. Mm-hmm. You know, just because the budget doesn't necessarily go up doesn't mean their expenses didn't go up because a person was there that wouldn't have been there otherwise.
Well, their expense might go up, but they get the same amount of tax dollars is my point. They are
fleecing the taxpayers. Yeah, but as their expenses go up, that results in the taxes eventually going up too.
So how much are we talking about? When you're talking about aggression, if it costs the taxpayers a penny extra a piece to put somebody in, it's not much to sort of as quantity goes here. So if the jail holds 100 people, it's currently got 75 people in it, and you keep one person from going, that's 76. And, you know, it's not going to change anything as far as electricity because the lights will go on and off at the same time. It's not going to change much as far as water goes because you're only talking about a little bit of hand washing, a little bit of toilet flushing here and, you know, shower taking. Mm-hmm. It's not going to cost much in food because the food sucks and it's all cheap and many of it's
actually not bad at the Keene Spiritual Retreat.
You can say that if you'd like. I've spent a great deal of my time in prison, and I can tell you that there's a lot of
prison in Florida.
Yeah, they had a lot of out of date food from Desert Storm, Desert Shield.
I've spent my time handling the food, and it was fresh. They had real eggs, real fruit.
Amazing stuff to me.
And Keene Spiritual Retreat, baby. Food there, so.
Yeah. So you're not talking about a great deal of money as far as the food goes.
Now, hold on a second, Mark. Were you at the new Spiritual Retreat?
Well, no, the old one.
It's better. The food's better now than it was back then. Because back then, you got the food from the old person's home, which was just down the street. So you guys kind of got the extras from the old person's home. And it just wasn't that great of food back then. It's better now than it was previously. Sorry,
I wasn't afraid of it.
So,
in many cases, you're not talking about a couple few dollars a day when that's spread out
it's
over
$2 a meal maximum. Yeah,
over something like I think it's like 50,000 households, 40,000 households in the county. You're not talking about much as far as incarcerating somebody. There's just not a lot of cost to incarceration.
But then there are always all these backup positions now that I have to fall back on to defend, assuming you're right about what you've just said. Did they even do it?
Sure.
Can you believe the people that are saying they did? Who did they do it to? What were the circumstances? And the final one would be... what are all the victimless crime charges that they're tacking on to this murder or whatever?
Well, certainly if they're victimless crime charges, then that's a no-brainer. Obviously, that's a guilty, but you're going to have a tough time convincing people that jury nullification is valid if on the same hand you are also saying, we should apply this to every case. Hang on, more coming up here at 8:55.
Probably didn't belong in the pamphlet.
4:53, it's Free Talk Live.
The economy is teetering on the edge. Spending and taxes are at all-time highs. Average Americans are hanging on by their fingertips. Is the American dream dead? Can it be restored? Join us at Freedom Fest, the world's largest gathering of free minds, in Las Vegas, July 8th through 11th, to hear the historic debate between Paul Krugman and Steve Moore. Plus, Senator Mike Lee, publisher Steve Forbes, billionaire Steve Wynn, and media mogul Glenn Beck tell us how America finds her way back. Discover the new American dream. Register today at freedomfest.com to find out. That's freedomfest.com.
Good people need help. The Homeowners Association said we had weeds and fined us $25. We told them they had the wrong house. They said if we didn't pay it, they'd file a lien. Our attorney demanded photographs, witnesses, and told them if they couldn't provide this, they must cease and desist. Issue solved. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. The live Memorial Day edition continues here. Plenty of time for you with your thoughts. If you want to share them here, our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show. Add our username there, which is lrn.fm. Just send over a contact request first. We'll approve it once we notice it coming in. And then after that, you can call us easily on Skype. And again, username lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
And don't forget to check out more of Dave over on his, I don't know if you call it a website, ridleyreport.com currently forwards to your YouTube channel, does it not?
Correct.
Okay, so go to ridleyreport.com and hit that subscribe button. And Dave Ridley will keep you up to date with a lot of the things that are going on here in New Hampshire. In fact, a lot of stuff that nobody else goes to. You were talking about this during one of the breaks, Dave, that you like to focus on places and things that are happening where you're the only activist to show up to cover that.
Yeah, the biggest difference mathematically is the difference between zero and one. And mm-hmm. that's also true in civics. You know, a place where they go do something, they have like a government meeting and there's no opposition. It's dramatically different if there is slight opposition from no opposition. And one person can make that happen.
And yeah. You do, and you've been actually going recently to Keene-related stuff.
like the school board meeting here, and also the we just had a power failure here. Anyway, the school board meeting and the Keene City Council, you're peppering them with questions in your traditional kind of ambush interview style. Those are very entertaining. They're up right now over at RidleyReport.com. Plus, if you're getting online at all, you need to know how to protect yourself, and ProXPN can help you with that. Just go to ProXPN.com/FTL. You can download their software for free that will encrypt your data connection, so your internet service provider will no longer know what you're doing online when you're using ProXPN. It's for Windows, Mac, iOS devices, as well as Android and Linux. So pretty much anything that you're using, whether it's your smartphone, your laptop, your desktop computer at home, ProXPN can work for you. You can go and get started with their free account at proxpn.com/FTL, but you'll likely want to upgrade to their premium account so you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you can use promo code FTL50 to get 50% off the price of the annual account. So, heck of a deal on some great privacy protection. Go and get started right now for free over at proxpn.com/FTL. Now, gentlemen, did you feel like there was more that we should cover on this jury nullification issue? Dave, you can't be serious when you say you want people to vote to acquit everybody.
I'm serious, but I'm open to changing my mind. I could be wrong about this. There may be something I'm missing. But it seemed to have some positive effect in Tyler when it was tried there.
Tyler, Texas. Well, I do have a question from a listener here. Just curious, what do we have in the way of stories from people who have accomplished a nullification? So where has this worked, Ian? I recall there was...
Where has what worked? Nullification?
Jury nullification.
In New Hampshire, the story of Doug Darrell is the best example that I can give. He was a Rastafarian, he's still around, a Rastafarian. This was only 2 or 3 years ago now that this transpired. And he got busted for growing pot plants, cannabis cultivation, which is a serious felony level charge here in New Hampshire. Unfortunately, it's still illegal to do that sort of thing. And so he was facing felonies, which meant many years in prison, possibly. And in this particular case, it wasn't the handing out of flyers that got him acquitted. It was the fact that a Free State Project participant, an early mover for the Free State Project, she was on his jury. And when the jury came in for deliberations, she was able to flip the entire jury to not guilty, which is an amazing persuasive ability.
It's amazing.
On her part. And it really just, you know, goes to show how, I mean, you can't say this about all jurors, but when you think you're the only one, like when the first vote happened, it was 11-1. She was the only person voting for not guilty. She flipped the other 11 to not guilty. And she did it because she had the gumption, the wherewithal, the stick-to-itiveness to be able to stand her ground and say, look, this is wrong. What's happening to this guy? He didn't hurt anybody. He shouldn't go to prison for this. We should find him not guilty. Now, I don't know exactly what she said to persuade them, but I imagine
we had her on the air. We did do an interview with her.
Yeah, that's right. Kathleen Converse was her name. If you search our archives for her name, I bet you that episode will come up.
Yeah, Converse, like Converse shoes.
Yeah, Kathleen Converse.
I imagine.
And she's the perfect character for this, too, because she's kind of got that grandmotherly look to her.
Yeah.
I don't know if she is a grandma, but she's, you know, looks like she's in her early 60s, late 50s, or
something like that.
You know, maybe mid 60s, something like that. And she looks like she should be on a jury. And so she got back there and she did everything that it took to make that happen. And she saved that man from prison.
But this is why salespeople make so much money, is that it's very, very difficult to convince someone else to do anything. Much easier to do it yourself, but to convince someone else to do something is rocket science. It's rocket effing science. So I just don't understand. I do understand that we do not have more results as a result of like handing things out in person.
Right.
I wouldn't expect a lot of results.
Right, I agree. Yeah. Having a person there is going to be more persuasive than the pamphlet. There's no doubt about that.
Well, that one person can hang a jury, and you know, that's the end of the story.
But it doesn't hurt to have the pamphlets, and I feel like it's worth. I still feel like it's worth my effort, even though I don't get an outpouring of thank you so much. You know, every now and then someone will say thank you, and that's good enough for me. If I get some appreciation,
I'll bet you
if
that guy really appreciates that the whole
Doug Darrell.
Yeah, Doug Darrell probably believes that that one action, you know, is worth all of the Free State Free Staters have moved here to New Hampshire.
Well, there's an occasional there's another method of outreach that I think also can help. So I was at a courthouse doing Don't Take a Plea Deal outreach, which is my normal thing at court because jury's only once a month. Don't Take a Plea Deal, we do like 10 days a month out here. So the first 2 weeks of the month in Cheshire County, we've got people outside the courthouse handing out this plea deal information to people who are coming in. One day I was at court handing out that information, and I was actually in court because I happened to be I happen to have a trial for myself for speeding. And so I, of course, you know, they always make me wait till a lot of the times they'll make me wait till the end. In this case, they had made me wait till the end because the bureaucrat who was accusing me hadn't shown up yet, so the cop wasn't there. And of course, if they start the trial without the witness, then I can motion to dismiss when they call the witness if they're not there, and they'll throw the case out.
And
so,
you will.
So they waited until the very end. So I got to see all of the cases that came before me, and one of them was a woman who was being arraigned on felony marijuana growing charges. She was a real long-haired hippie-looking lady. She had a husband with her who also looked kind of like a hippie guy. And so I thought, wow, you know, these people are in a bad way. I'm going to give them a jury flyer. So when they walked out of the courtroom, I got up, grabbed one of my jury flyers from inside my backpack. Now, this is the courthouse where I'm not banned from handing out flyers inside
that
the courthouse.
That narrows it down.
Yeah. Well, that's actually every other courthouse. The one that I'm banned from is here in Cheshire County. I cannot hand out flyers. No one can hand out flyers in
inside
Cheshire County.
Building.
In fact, the way the order is written, it actually would prohibit the clerks from handing you papers at the clerk's window, but obviously it's not being enforced on them. So anyway, I approached this lady and her husband, and I said to them, hey, I want you to know about jury nullification. This is, you know, an option for you. This is something you should know about. It's like, yeah, I overheard what you were being charged with. This is something that you should know about. And they were so appreciative of it. They had not heard about jury nullification. I gave them a little briefing as to what it was. And they were super, super appreciative of it. So I think also giving that information to the defendant can be helpful as well.
That may be really actually pretty efficient. Because if you think about it, the person who is getting that flyer, they may have had no chance, like their attorney may not tell them about it, and it gives them a chance to tell the attorney and
that's
at least
right.
Bring it up at trial. It might never be mentioned at trial if not for your pamphlet.
That's right. And also, at least you're in New Hampshire where this stuff can be mentioned at trial. So that's another thing that is an assistance to us here, is that the defense can actually talk about it to the jury in New Hampshire.
So that automatically helps every defendant bring that into a trial.
Yeah, exactly.
If we got the message to every defendant.
Which, as I say, we're not doing regularly.
That's close. So we're getting there.
If the defendant is walking through the front door the morning of the trial, they could very well get one of those flyers. Because usually, you know, well, I guess if we're there on jury selection day, the defendant may not be there. Depends. Anyway, more coming up here in moments. 855 453. Let's talk about the decline of the U.S. newspaper here in moments and your calls and thoughts if you make them at 855 453. This is Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm.
Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from HiddenHolster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. The original hidden holster.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here on this live Memorial Day edition of the program at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Yeti and Dave Ridley and Mark in the studio here. We've got Skype as well. You can Skype in here at username lrn.fm. We, over the last several years on Free Talk Live, have been paying attention to the decline and the fall of print media. A lot of print media is having a difficult time out there. The daily papers, of course, have been shutting down completely or cutting their print runs to, you know, just a few times a week. Now, Dave, is that are you being facetious with that? That all? Are you actually sad?
They brought it on themselves. Although, you know, I mean, we need a strong press in the U.S., but we weren't getting it from the papers anyway.
No, they're very obedient to the state. They're always, you know, bending over for the politicians and never really asking the tough questions. Or,
I mean, there are exceptions, but yeah, by and large.
But usually the exceptions are like Russia Today and Al Jazeera, which are not U.S.-based organizations. Those are the ones that seem to do the best, at least on for the mainstream level, doing the best reporting. Obviously, IndyMedia is a different story.
Well, there have been some exceptions inside the U.S. too. I mean,
that's
local.
True. Every now and then. Nationally. But it seems like the local papers are more likely to be better at criticizing even stuff outside of their state or outside of their direct purview.
Yeah, well, local papers are obviously very dependent on local advertisers, and local advertisers like good news. They like, oh, yeah, the fluffy pieces. They don't like that stuff going after, in many cases, the advertisers or businessmen. They're connected with the local politicians, and they don't want corruption shown or bad crime statistics or these sorts of things. They don't want that stuff.
Yeah, God forbid a business owner should be protected from corruption.
Yeah, indeed.
All right, so here's the news from the Pew Research Center. This is the latest on the print industry.
specifically newspapers. Over the past two decades, major newspapers across the country have seen a recurring cycle of ownership changes and steep declines in value. The San Diego Union-Tribune was the latest example of this, as it officially changed ownership brands on Thursday for the third time in 6 years.
Jeez.
The most recent purchase came from Tribune Publishing Company for the amount of $85 million, including 9 community papers. Still waiting for a buyer is the 96-year-old New York tabloid The Daily News, which owner Mort Zuckerman put on the sale block this spring. But there seems to be far from a stampede of interested buyers. Steep revenue and circulation declines across the newspaper industry have left many newspapers struggling. Over the past decade, weekday circulation has fallen 17% and ad revenue more than 50%.
Okay. Circulation 17% in what period of time?
Over the past decade.
Okay.
Now, other
not terrible, actually.
But that's so, on average. So other papers, I looked at the Keene Sentinel, actually, for an article I wrote about them a couple years ago, and I pulled the circulation numbers from their official certifier, and I looked back years, you know, like 20 years back, and there was a decline from the 90s to the aughts, you know, like in the beginning of the aughts, but from the aughts to today, actually within the last 5 years or 7 years specifically, there's been a humongous decline in subscriptions of the local paper. But yet they managed to keep it going. They had a busy, bustling newsroom when I went in there a couple years ago for an interview, and I was surprised by that. I expected to see a skeleton crew in there. So despite their tremendous decline in subscriptions, they still seem to have it together.
Well, you know, partly it's probably because they don't really have much TV coverage out here, also, you know, they're so old, they're very, you know, very
established.
One of the oldest newspapers in America.
Yeah. But it's still annoying whenever I go to their website and it's like, give us the blood of a virgin in order to see, you know, this article, because you've already looked at 3 articles this month.
Here's how you get around that.
ProXPN. Right?
Well, ProXPN's one way, but you can actually just create an incognito browser or a private browsing window.
You just type in M. Do you take out the www and you just put an M in?
The mobile site will work for you, too?
Yeah, and it's just fine.
Okay. So there's multiple ways to get around that one. So steep revenue and circulation declines across the industry again. They're pretty hurting. In 2014 alone, 3 different media companies decided to spin off more than 100 newspaper properties, in large part to protect their still robust broadcast or digital divisions. Amazon.com founder Jeff Bezos may have stunned many with his $250 million purchase of the Washington Post, which was last sold at auction in 1933. But other recent sales of major papers show dramatic devaluation and suggest a tough road ahead for the newspaper industry. So they look here on over 2 decades, major U.S. newspapers declining rapidly in value. Value of the deals that they're giving numbers for here. So they're going back in time. They're going to give you 1993 for the New York Times buying the Globe owner. So we're talking about the Boston Globe here in this case. The Boston Globe and the Worcester Telegram and Gazette. $1.8 billion in 1993, the New York Times company buys Globe owner-affiliated publications, $1.8 billion. 6 years later, in 1999, Times company bought the Telegram and Gazette for $419 million. And then in 2013, businessman John Henry buys both of those papers and the related properties. How much?
Half that.
So half of $1.8 billion plus, so about $1 billion is what you would say. Try $71 million. Mm. $71 million. That's a valuation change, they say here, from 1993 to 2013 of minus 96%.
Oh, my God.
Philadelphia Inquirer and the Philly Daily News, their change was for, minus 91% from 06 to 2012, where in 2006, McClatchy Company sold the papers to Philadelphia Media Holdings, LLC. Then, 4 years later, Philadelphia Media Network bought the properties at auction. So they sold them for $604 million in 2006. Then at auction, they were purchased for $151 million in 2010. Then in 2012, another company bought the papers for $56 million.
Jeez.
So it's just down and down and down the drain. I mean, these companies that are buying these papers, they must be suicidal, it seems. I mean, they really have to have quite the business plan in mind to try to save these struggling And I say struggling in the nicest way here, operations.
Yeah, you've got to really believe you can do something. Now, I must admit to believing that I could change things too for a newspaper. Now, I'm not ready to slap down the money for one of these newspapers, but I can say that I think that they have to do something entirely different. There's a classification of newsprint that's not doing as bad, and that's the
weekly freebie.
Yeah, right? The weekly freebie, the penny pincher, the swap shop,
the fish wrapper.
Yeah, that one, and it's not doing bad. And the reason is that they, all their money is basically all their, they're salespeople that get a commission, and then they do these sort of happy articles and that kind of thing. Well, I don't think that's, and they give it away for free. As a matter of fact, they'll send it to your house. And I think that they need to go to that free model. People do want newspapers. Newspapers have value, but they, they're just not willing to pay what it costs for them.
Right.
And I think they should go to a more advertiser thick and system, and then give them away at least at the at some locations. Maybe you charge people for delivery, but I mean delivery costs money in the same way that restaurants will charge you one price at the door and one price at your door, and so there's a difference. So maybe give them away at the little newspaper pullout things or whatever, mm-hmm. and then charge people a certain amount for having them delivered to their house or whatever. But advertisers want eyes, and you'll get the eyes if you just get it in people's hands.
Well, another thing that might work is if they did two things. First of all, making the paper available as some kind of audio format so that you can listen to the paper. And also, if they were to actually be interesting, cover the real controversies and conflicts that are going on in a town. They don't necessarily have to generate any of their own, but they're always fights and factions, and if you focus on that conflict, people will read. People are interested in conflict,
and they'll pass it around as well. It's a really interesting
article. Happy paper thing. I mean, I guess for some reason it seems to be working out somewhat well for their weeklies, but no one really expects most of the commerce oriented weeklies to do that. I know in Dallas they had a paper called The Observer, and it was weekly, and it was
more indie media kind of?
Yeah, it was very harsh reporting on everything the government did in Dallas.
I love that. And I'm so glad Darrell W. Perry does that here. He's like a one-man newsprint publishing operation. He puts together his own newspaper on a weekly basis, and then he distributes the paper. And it would be great if he had a bigger crew helping him with that. But, that's one of those projects that you really have to be interested in print publishing, I think, to get involved in that. But maybe more people will move here as part of the Free State Project, and we'll see things like that expand. Before we go, I want to give you a few more numbers here. Chicago Sun-Times, 1994, was purchased for $284 million. Then, in 2011, sold the paper and the related properties, $21 million. The paper filed for bankruptcy in 2009. Minneapolis Star Tribune, down 93% from 98 to 2012, from a $1.7 billion sale down to $122 million in 2012. Just incredible. Incredible. All right, so we'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, at freetalklive.com, and check out Dave on his YouTube channel, RidleyReport.com.
Jared Gilchrist was surfing when he was attacked by a shark that took his leg. Thanks for being with us, big guy.
Thanks, this is tight.
What was going through your mind when you first realized that you were there with a shark all alone in open water?
I felt like a total badass. It bit into my leg and started shaking it back and forth, and at that point I just felt, yes, this is sweet.
I can't imagine what it would have been like to see the teeth sinking into your leg like
that. It was sick. At one point, I just saw my leg just floating there in the water. It was awesome.
Okay, we're joined now via satellite by Dr. Brian Caddy. What condition was Jared's leg in when you first saw him?
It was in pretty rough shape. The shark had scissored through the muscle, and it was all just like hanging off the bone. It was nuts.
Yeah, I kept touching it. It was slimy as hell.
Yeah, totally. It was insane.
Well, doctor, how do you deal with something like this?
Well, you're never fully prepared for an injury this freaking cool. We just tried to stop the blood loss, and we took a bunch of photos because it's hysterical to freak out the nurses with gnarly shit like this.
This is the Onion News Network.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, May 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.04 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,204 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports in the 9 days since the fall of Palmyra, the Islamic State has rounded up government supporters and carried out mass executions, with the Syrian state media claiming over 400 people killed, mostly women and children. The Syrian Observatory for Human Rights confirmed the basics of the story, affirming it had documented mass executions in the ancient Oasis city, but putting the toll at 217. Among the 217, the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights said about 150 of them were captured members of the Syrian military seized during the fall of the region, with the rest being civilians, including a handful of children. The fall of Palmyra put the Islamic State even more deeply in control of central Syria and has expanded their territory in the country to the point where they are estimated to control about 50% of the nation by area. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, while awaiting a decision in civil contempt proceedings late last week, Arizona Sheriff Joe Arpaio asked the public to help fund his legal fees, according to a report. The Los Angeles Times quoted Arpaio as writing an email stating, "In some instances, I have to personally pay for attorneys to represent me in these cases. I do not have the personal wealth or the wherewithal to keep up with the costly demands of paying for attorneys to defend me." Arpaio is being sued by immigration rights groups and is in the midst of a contempt of court hearing over whether he disregarded a 2011 court order to refrain from profiling and detaining Latino immigrants. On Friday, Arpaio's lawyers filed requests for a new judge to replace U.S. District Court Judge G. Murray Snow. The filing reads, "No reasonable person with knowledge of the facts can deny that Judge Snow is now investigating and presiding over issues involving his own family." In 2013, Snow ruled the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office had systematically profiled against Latinos in the law enforcement operations. Arpaio is scheduled to appear before Snow in June, though the filing could affect the timetable. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports two people were killed in flash flooding and severe storms in Texas and Oklahoma that forced evacuations and rooftop rescues and left thousands without power. The National Weather Service reported river flooding across southern Oklahoma and central Texas, where 6 to 9 inches of rain fell between late Saturday and early Sunday morning. Flash flooding remained a threat on Sunday from central Iowa into southern Texas, where the heaviest rainfall was expected. The National Weather Service said as much as 3 inches of rain could fall in East Central Texas on Monday and possibly more in some areas. Helicopters were used to rescue people off rooftops in Hays County and Central Texas. County officials reported on Sunday more than 1,000 people were rescued or evacuated from 400 homes. Local officials at an afternoon news conference said debris piles were nearly 20 feet high. An unidentified man was found dead from the flooding in San Marcos. In San Antonio, electric utility company CPS Energy said it would take up to 48 hours for power to be restored to 2,600 customers. In Oklahoma, which also had weekend flooding, one firefighter died in Claremore, about 30 miles northeast of Tulsa. He was responding to a call to help about 10 people trapped in their home by flood water and was swept into a storm drain and died. Another firefighter who rushed to his aid was also swept into a storm drain but survived with minor injuries. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
McDonald's is now offering bereavement prices, and a sexual predator gets tenure. This is The Onion Week in Review. This Wednesday, Samsung announced the release of its brand new Really Big F***ing television. Representatives for the South Korean electronics manufacturer told reporters at a press conference that the and gargantuan of an electronics product boasted a variety of new features, including being super heavy and having a screen that was probably 100 f***ing inches wide for all they knew.
We here at Samsung think this new product will appeal to today's consumers who are looking for a television that's really, really huge. I mean, this thing is built like a f***ing Mack truck. You just really have to see it to believe it.
In other news, an important decision is sent up to the company's highest idiot. And an area mother doesn't see why Thai people need to make food so spicy. Today's Onion Review was sponsored by Bamboo Garden, voted the best family-owned Chinese restaurant in Idaho for 5 years running.
This is the Onion News Network.
Oh, man. I love the Onion News, man. Why do they have to make Thai food so spicy? She doesn't understand it.
Welcome to Liberty Conspiracy Radio on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM. For streaming us over the airwaves, thank you for tuning in or for carrying us on an affiliate. I'm Gardner Goldsmith, available at Skype under G-A-R-D-N-E-R dot Goldsmith. Great to come in after Free Talk Live with guest Dave Ridley tonight. Very good stuff. That was awesome. I love listening to those guys. Especially, I love that final conversation they were having about the dying newspapers, the traditional dinosaur media. And I loved it when Ian was talking about Chicago Tribune. It basically filing for bankruptcy. Originally, it was sold for over $200 million, and then it was sold for like $21 million a few years later. Oh, man. I like that. Okay. Welcome to the pro. I hate to see certain people losing money, but, you know, when it's part of the pop media and they're incredibly biased towards the state and really left wing and that sort of stuff and collectivist, then I'm glad that people are no longer watching them, reading them, doing that sort of thing to the dinosaur media. And instead, they're turning to alternative sources of media, which the politicians do not like. LG Grande here with you. Buenos, whatever time zone you call home. Thank you for being part of the conspiracy for freedom. The people who believe in leaving their neighbors alone to be free and exchange and deal with each other in voluntary actions. Good to have you here. Time for the news, one and all. Yes, one of those old dinosaur news themes. Tonight on the program, we will open up the Skype lines a little bit earlier and